were Michael Slater, James Brayshaw and Mark Taylor.
Thank you, Mark. Nicholas and Ian Healy. Yes, Adam Gilchrist coming out of retirement for this match on his 37th birthday as well. Great to see him back playing, well, any form of the game of cricket, but particularly 2020 cricket, which is really right up his alley. Exciting player. He will be missed by the game, but it's terrific to see him out there tonight. And as Mark said, we can actually talk to Gilly. And 37 today, mate, how are you feeling?
Oh, the heart's racing. You never lose the nerves, I've worked out. Doesn't matter what the game is. But I'm very, very thrilled to be out here again. I didn't think I'd be back out here this soon or ever again. Centre, please.
And you decided to bat first, mate. Did you realise that they've got Peter Siddle, Sean Tate in their bowling lineup, Brett Jeeves? They've got a few quicks in this side, mate.
I know. I just figured that I might be better equipped to do it straight away rather than after 20 overs of keeping, so get it out of the way. See how we go. Yeah, that's that way a bit, please.
All right, Michael Dighton at the other end from Tasmania. Solid season last year for the Tasmanian side. Good right-hand opening batsman, tall man, good striker of the ball as well. And it'll be Brett Jeeves to bowl the first over of the match. He'll bowl to Adam Gilchrist, as we've just said, has decided to bat first. He won the toss for the All-Stars side. He's decided also to face the first ball, which is, I suppose it's good, brave cricket. And I welcome to the microphone James Brayshaw and Michael Slater. Evening, gentlemen.
Thanks, Tub. Evening to everyone. I can't believe Adam Gilchrist doing this. I would have thought when you've been out of the game for a year, Slats, you might ferret yourself away to six or seven, but he's facing the music.
It's quite Lights. Often you come out like Lights. This, though, JB, and he could blitz 80. He'll be relaxed. I know the heart's pumping, but you don't lose it. He could get a globe as well, but I reckon the talent will come through. Let's not forget, the last time he played was actually in the Indian Premier League. So it's months down. He's been doing the trail around Australia in the last couple of weeks, selling his book, True Colours. And as he just said a moment ago, he didn't think he'd be out there with the batting gear on so soon here in Australia.
Yes, yes. He's looking for a run, and he gets it. That will relieve him somewhat. He's actually looking for two. Oh, no, don't get run out, Gilly. Gilly, you're still keen. You're looking for two.
Yeah, bit carried away there. I think the words Tate at the other end might be ringing in my mind. Anyway.
Mate, it's only ball number two, mate. Wait till ball number five or six.
Yeah, right, mate, no worries. Yeah, that's right. That's where I will clap on the back burners and get down there, I think. Oh, wow.
Well, you're off the mark, mate. That's good news.
That's right.
No duck on your birthday.
Yeah.
Oh, that could be six. That's beautiful. That scrap. Oh, my word. That's a long way back. What a way to start for Dighton.
That's his first ball. He's just helped himself to a maximum. And an unconventional one, too. Ball got a bit big on him. He got a nice piece of it, and that has gone a long way back.
Jeeves is not slow. That ball at 137 kilometres an hour, and he really skipping in. The extra bounce, it was a top edge, but it kept flying. Straight into the stands.
And now four. Michael Dighton, he's in good touch. That's why he's in this side. 10 runs from two balls. That's from one of his teammates too. He'll be enjoying that.
It's too short at the moment from Jeeves, trying hard to deliver the pace early. There's the six. In fact, it was more. It was a top edge, but it's closer to the middle than a genuine edge, and here's the one to follow it up. Consecutive boundaries, great way to start a 2020 fixture, and that's a real nerve settler.
Well, he's doing some moving around, actually, Michael Dighton. The first two balls, he sort of backed away a little bit, gave himself some room. On that occasion, he was going across. Now, we've already spoken to Adam Gilchrist today, who's wired up out the middle. We've also got Mike Hussey, the Australian captain today. Matthew Hayden there at first slip. He's also wired for sound, as is Andrew Simons, and it's great to see Simo back in the Australian colours.
Oh, shot.
Oh, that's beautifully struck as well. It's gone. Well, 16 runs from Michael Dighton from four balls faced. What a start for him. The A's, none for 17.
Afternoon, driver. Would you just mind buying it?
Hot and spicy.
KFC's Hot and Spicy Fillets Hotbox packs a real punch. With two delicious fiery fillets, supercharged sauce, and your favourite sides. KFC's Hot and Spicy Fillets Hotbox.
17 runs from the first over. Brett Gees bowled that first over. And Michael Dighton, his Tasmanian teammate, took him apart. Sean Tate will bowl the second over from the Stanley Street end of the ground. And it's also great to see him back bowling for Australia. Spent some time out of the game. A quick word with him before the start of play today, and he sounded very keen to me. Sounded fresh.
Where's the X factor for me, Tub, in Australian cricket? Tate. He's got plenty. You just got to hope he can focus and channel it.
Yeah, great to see that man on your screen back, Andrew Symons. So much written and said about Andrew Symons in the past month and a half, and he's back out there. He's going to really enjoy tonight. And I'm sure enjoying being back around his teammates. But Sean Tate, a delight for him to get back out there. Had a chat with him as well, Tub, and he might play the first game again.
That's nicely played. There's a trademark Gilchrist shot. Beautifully timed. Gillies away.
Well, this is why he was one of the all-time greats. You just give him a little bit of room. Doesn't matter that it was coming at 150 clicks. Just have a look at some of this. Into the gap, middle of the bat. The boundary of formality. Talk about Adam Gilchrist. There we are, Slats, the true colours on sale now at all the good bookstores.
Yeah, Slats, you were saying that he hasn't done a lot of batting since the Indian Premier League. What it was about, April of this earlier this year, but in recent times, as James Bracer just alluded to, he's been travelling the country promoting his biography, True Colours. It's about $50. I think it's about 1,000 pages too. There's plenty of reading in there. Not enough pictures for my liking.
Yeah, well, I'm reading it at the moment. It's a good read.
You'll have it done by about 2015 or something like that.
I put it down a couple of times, exhausted.
Oh, he goes over cover. Hasn't quite got it out of the middle this time, but it'll go.
Oh. If he had the nerves, they are starting to settle, maybe, but then he looks at the other end and Sean Tate's still going to be steaming in, and having gone for two boundaries, he'll just get a little bit quicker with each delivery, you'd think, but you never lose it. He hasn't had a net. Well, he might have had one last night when he got into Brisbane, and one this morning, but that must have felt good, Gilly.
I did have a net just before the game, foolishly, and I'm starting to cramp up already, Flat. I'm gone.
There you go, quick single. That's a nice one. Get up the other end, call your heels.
Get out of the kitchen. Oh, dear.
What about Dighton?
Unbelievable. I've just been amazed at what this game, this 2020 format's done to the game of cricket. Off the mark, over deep third man. Pretty well in control. It's a little bit slow, not a lot of swing for six runs. So, saw it through the IPL, seen it in all the 2020 comps around the world. The preparedness of guys to take it on right from the start is unbelievable. What a courage.
Oh, that's four. I think that's probably byes. No wides given, so that'll be five. That was quick. That was right through Brad Haddin. He would have seen a ball do that for at least the last 6 weeks. Nothing in India got above about stump height.
Well, the control's not there at the moment for Sean Tate, but the wheels certainly are. He started off in the high 140s. He's touched 150 already in this over. What I spoke about, it's an X factor with this guy. He has genuinely got pace, and that is something Brad Haddin hasn't seen for a while.
No! It's 31 after two overs.
The new limited edition Ford Territory SR2 comes with over $5,500 worth of features at no extra cost. There's alloy wheels, cruise control, sports leather trim, and widescreen DVD player. The Territory SR2. Hurry, it'll be gone before you know it.
Terrific start from the All-Stars. They won the toss and batted. 31 after two overs. Dight, 16 off five balls.
Oh, he's playing it nicely now, Adam Gilchrist. Just a quick single. There you go, Dighton back up, taking strike. And a man patrolling the covers out there. And great to see him in Aussie colours again, Andrew Simon. Simo, great to see you back.
Yeah, good to be back out here. Should be good. Good fun. They've got a cracking start here. What about that first shot?
Yeah, you're going to be expected to prowl and execute one of those run-outs again, straight up.
Yeah, we might have to run Dykes out. He's looking pretty good, Nick.
How are you feeling, mate? Is it a bit like a first game for a while?
Yeah, they've let me loose tonight, haven't they?
Oh, that's beautiful hit. That's three sixes to Dighton. He's only faced six balls.
Not only three of them, two of them have been straight back over the bowler's head. There's no point questioning this. That's gone all the way. There we are. The two hands held aloft. This is a clean hit. It's a big boy, Michael Dighton. And bang. Right out of the guts. Pick the bones out of that.
Slow ball, well bowled. He's got it away. This could well be four. It runs away very quickly in that part of the ground.
I'll tell you what this is showing, that Michael Dighton's been around state cricket for many, many years, but the talent that is there and the reason Australian cricket is so strong is the fact that these sort of guys exist, and you see him starting innings in blistering pace like this, and you think, well, why isn't that a game earlier? He's a natural striker. He's come out with he's not intimidated at all. And he's certainly taking the pressure off Gilly, the captain at the other end, admiring this amazing start. 26 from seven balls.
And now mid-on's going back. Shows to me how strong some of the players are these days. We talk about people like Hayden and Gilchrist and what have you. Oh, that could be six more. That's the biggest one yet. That's about 12 rows back, straight over the side screen. Clean as you like.
He's taking the mick, Michael Dighton. He's on 32 from eight pills, and he has not missed the middle of the bat. It's unbelievable. Brett G's got no idea. He's given himself a bit of room here and just smoked it over the side screen.
You know, the problem with being in the nets against one another all those years, he knows where G's going to put it. He's thinking, geez, I wish I could play against you, and he is today.
Oh, that's well taken. That's well caught. No, it's a wide call. Well, there was certainly a deflection. Now, whether it was a bit of swing after the ball that bounced, but there was a noise. Brad Haddon certainly thought he had a catch. It certainly was a wide if he didn't hit it, but gee, it sounded like a nick to me.
It's got very wide on the crease, but no, daylight between edge and the ball. Brad Haddon, terrific take.
Lord Simons can't get there. He's riding his luck at the moment, Michael Dighton, but doing it beautifully. That's the 50 up already for the All-Stars, and running in the third over.
Well, that's the first ball that hasn't hit the middle of the bat for Dighton. He chunked that one a bit, but it is extraordinary. As you can see, the high-definition pictures picking that up beautifully. Missed it comfortably, but it's what this game's bringing to the table. We haven't even finished the third over, and the batting side have already brought up the 50. It is amazing.
I feel sorry for Mike Hussey at the moment. He's just come back from India. Had one day at home. He got over to Perth for one day. Flew back to the Gabba for this match. Obviously, the test match next week. And now he's got to try and stop this onslaught. Oh, that misses everything. Just. None for 51 after three.
This is good.
What?
This, rate it.
50 good reasons to switch your home and contents insurance to AAMI. Call 1322 44 today.
It'll save us some money.
Yeah. Right. But What do you reckon the other 49 reasons are? Wait, what are you looking at me like that for? Lucky, you're with Amy.
So Dyke 34, Gilchrist 11. Not often Adam Gilchrist gets left behind. Ian Healy down there on the boundary with Shane Watson.
I'm not sure Gilly's worried about being left behind. The All-Stars, they're race to 50. No wicket for 51. This is the start of the fourth. Sean Tate. Going to be ripping them out here.
We're in the high 140s again with Sean Tate. Might be a good time to talk to the skipper, Mike Hussey, out there. Huss, you're in the middle of a firestorm at the moment.
You got any ideas for me?
Yeah, don't bowl.
Well, Andrew Simon said maybe I should come on and lead from the front, but I don't know. It's all right. I'm thinking about giving Jeevesy a rest and maybe bowl Pete Siddle from that end now.
Yeah, I saw him warming up. It's been nice, clean hitting from Dyke.
What do you reckon about spin from that end? Take the pace off it, maybe.
Good bit of swing there from Sean Tate. Might have swung too far. He certainly is getting that pace up there. That's 148, that one. Worry any batsman, particularly one who hasn't probably had a bat for about, well, I would reckon at least 4 or 5 months.
But too much talent in the Tate package not to see more of him at this level. It's good to see him back playing well and in a good place.
He certainly can get it up there. He can get it in the high 150s even at his absolute best. Oh, I don't know how that's missed him. A wry smile there from Sean Tate. I just wonder, though, it seems to bowl his best in the shorter versions of the game, where he really can just let it go for 2 or 3 overs.
Yeah, and I think for the moment he should be focusing on the shorter forms of the game for Australian representation. But I know he's had a couple of Sheffield Shield games for South Australia. He's done a tough flat pitches, and you know, he's called on to come back and bowl those explosive spells right through the day. The tendency is, though, and I'm sure captains start out and say, well, this bloke, he's our strike weapon. We'll use him in short spells, bring him back quite regularly, but short spells. But if you're not getting wickets, you tend to, you know, the tendency is to bowl him a couple overs longer than you first anticipated. But when he knows he's only got 10 in a 50-over game, or 4 as it is tonight, he just rips in. And I think for the time being, when it comes to playing for Australia, this is probably where it sits.
I'll just quickly speak to the batsman, Adam Gilchrist. Gilly, this time last year you were keeping to Tate and they were slapping in. Yep. He's in the high 140s, early 150s. What are you seeing?
Nothing, obviously. Look, I like this Australian team. I want to see them back up. I want to just keep them in the game, keep them away from Dighton. He's on fire.
Hang on, what's he got here? I'm waiting for the short one.
Oh, yes! Get out of there.
Tate, just the one from it. 52 after 4.
These child stars were everyone's favourite. But what's the real story?
Too much success, too much money, too much fame.
Who really triumphed? Only 20-1 child stars. Where are they now? Sunday, 6:30.
Wins International Summer of Cricket. Brought to you by our telecast partner, Ford Backyard Series Cricket. Registration's now open. Visit fordbsc.com.au.
Well, tonight is the beginning of a new era for television, or television cricket in Australia. It's our first high-definition broadcast, complete with 5.1 Dolby surround sound. And for those of you at home who've got a high-definition television, this is terrific. We've got monitors in our commentary box here, and the pictures are absolutely superb. Peter Siddle will be the new bowler for Australia. Young man from Victoria. An excellent season last year for that state. Played one test match in India. That'll be at least 4, if not 6. That certainly, well, it shocked Gilchrist, yeah. Interested to know where Gilly took that one from. I think probably his nose, right in front of the face.
It's a good pace to start. Good bounce as well. The pitch looks like a belter. It's got good pace in it, good bounce. There's always a consistency playing up here at Gabba. Occasionally gets a bit green for a state game, but other than that, it's a great place for the bowlers early and certainly good for the batsmen. You get full reward.
He's got that better. He's flicked that away for four. That one's closer to the middle. That one was almost out of the middle, Gilly. What about the previous one? I reckon that was headed towards the ACA badge on the helmet.
Yeah, the panic button set in there. Geez, he's a strong boy. Obviously impressed in his debut in India with his muscle and his grunt. But, yeah, he just creeps onto you a bit quicker. The wicket has just seemed to be holding in the wicket a little bit. The ball has, but Pete Siddle's definitely getting it through.
They've got a fine leg out for you now, mate. You're obviously concerned about your hook shot.
Yeah. Yes! No! Sorry.
Oh, no ball called. Michael Dighton left stranded.
Sorry, Dighton.
Great call, Gilly.
Oh, that's right, the free hit. Gee, forgot about that.
Isn't that the old call in Australian cricket? Yes, no, and then a sorry. He's smiling, the boy at the other end. He wouldn't have been if it hit the stumps.
Dubby was brilliant at those calls.
I reckon that was the yes call till he heard the free hit and he thought, I'm staying down this end. I'm taking it.
Hey, I know. Can you hear me?
You've had enough already, Dighton. You stay up there.
Yeah, my name's Gilly, not Silly. All right, where am I going? Dighton reckons he's going short, so I'm going to back away. Oh, got it.
He's got it. Good enough, anyway. Oh, two bounces over the rope. Boring. What about the six? It was a free hit.
It was, yeah. I've normally missed my free hits in my 2020 career, but I'm just glad that I've got something off the square. Dighton's on fire. I can't get him on strike.
Sydney's going to back away, but I'm not sure whether the moose over wide mid-on was the go. Slats, but you've just got to improvise. It's what this game brings to batting.
I don't want him to give it away, though. He's got 24. It's not enough. Keep going, Gilly.
Yeah.
Yeah, good call, good single. Both Gilchrist and Dighton hitting a lot of boundaries. We've already had, what, 7 fours and 4 sixes already in only 4.5 overs. So the infield, the Australian infield, really are pushing back now. There's singles everywhere. That was Dighton's first ball over deep third man for six. And that was about his fourth or fifth ball he faced. And that set the tone for this sort of cameo partnership so far, which has yielded 66 runs from only 29 balls.
He's gone a little cold, Michael Dighton, after ripping it apart earlier. This is the batting to come. Have a look at some of this. Brad Hodge is a terrific player we know all about. Simon Caddish been in great form. Dan Marsh, Justin Langer coming back, one of the all-time stars of the game. And Quiney's been a very good nick as well for Victoria, as is McDonald. And Ryan Harris isn't the worst. Batting everywhere.
Oh, dropped it! That was almost brilliant from Peter Siddle. He did just about everything right, but couldn't hang on in the end. 66 after 5 overs.
Get a cracking deal at Harvey Norman's iPod Bonus Bonanza. Buy any iPod Nano and get a bonus Belkin AC charger. Buy any iPod Classic or iPod Touch and get a bonus charger plus bonus FM tuner. iPod Bonus Bonanza ends this weekend at Harvey Norman. Go!
If you see trees growing too close to power lines, call Aurora on 13 2004, because nothing is more important than your safety.
A terrific start. 13.2 runs per over at the moment. Plenty of batting to come, as James Brayshaw mentioned last over. So I don't really know what they could get from here. 200 plus the way they're going at the moment.
anything around 180 is a terrific score. So if you're getting 180 plus, they're certainly on track for 200. And that's an outstanding start by the All-Stars.
So I suppose from Mike Hussey's point of view, the captain of the Australian side, he'd be just trying to get through this over. This is the last over of the fielding restrictions. He can push more men back after this over.
And actually pegged it back pretty well, I reckon, the Aussies, because they were 50 after about the third ball of the third over. So 17 balls, I think, the first 50 took. So they've actually pegged it back. This is that incredible attempted catch from Siddle, last ball of the last over. He had a piece of it there, and then he had another go at it, you'll see here, almost. And then he has a third crack at it, and it's just out of reach.
Gee, I thought it had stuck that first one.
Bowling.
That's a terrific swinging delivery. Sean Tate keeping the ball up there. He hasn't bowled too much short at all. And they get their first wicket, the Aussies. It was quick again, Gilly, a little bit of swing as well.
Yeah, he actually bowled his last eight ball. Oh, the wide there was wide, obviously. But that last over, he seemed to hit a good length. And I think that's his greatest weapon. You're so worried about the short ball and the Yorker that you forget about a decent, you know, good length ball. But he's good to see him hitting some good areas. And that was a bit of fun. Thanks.
Love it in livings there from Adam Gilchrist, 25 from only 20 balls faced. Also good, as Adam Gilchrist alluded to there, to see Sean Tate getting the ball up there at around about 145, 150 k's per hour with a bit of swing. Good sign there for Australian cricket. As is this guy, Brad Hodge. He's been around a long time. Brad Hodge, 33 years of age. He's made a squillion runs for just about everyone he's played for, including county sides, Victoria. When he's played for Australia in a few test matches, he's got a test 200. Very good cricketer. Probably hasn't played anywhere near the number of games for Australia, as I'm sure he would have liked. And a lot of people probably think he should have.
He's in a time capsule too, Hodgie. He looks exactly the same now as he did when he first played. And that's the 13-odd years ago. That's a nice piece of bowling. The feet not quite there for Adam Gilchrist, understandable. We're talking about a 37-year-old and a man who hasn't played for a year, so we'll forgive him for that, but he's still got the job done. 25 from 20 and plenty of entertainment. Sean Tate, a wry smile.
Oh, good edge. It's safe. It's four. Oh, gee, there's that swing again. That one is around about 150 k's. That's his quickest ball. And he needed a second slip.
Well, this is his third over, so it's probably his last, Sean Tate, unless they want to bowl him out. I guess he might. And Matthew Hayden there at first slip. Oh, maybe he's just getting a bit old. Would have got that, got to that about 5 years ago, Haydos.
Yeah, unbelievable. Tell you what, Pats and I are talking about where we should stand here. I'm absolutely clueless, the pair of us. Seems like the wicket is a little bit inconsistent. Good luck, Huss.
Oh, trouble.
Haydos, good start to the All-Stars. And Gilly, well, he was in good nick. He hasn't lost too much in the few months out.
Seems to be striking him beautifully. Bit of a daunting prospect, though, as well. Coming in and facing Sloan Tate. And Pete Siddle seems to be getting up ahead of steam after the frustrating 8 weeks he would have had in India. A great talent, though. I'm very excited for him in his selection.
Man goes out now for Michael Dighton. Andrew Symons is the man pushing out on the point boundary.
We can have a look. That's a direct hit. It looked comfortable for Dighton. But we're going to a third umpire.
He's labouring through that single. Xavier Doherty, who's got this fabulous opportunity tonight. He's been included into the Australian 12 after the withdrawal from Michael Clarke, and that is probably out. On the line, out. Is it crossed over? It is so close, so you can see why they've gone to the third. Rod Tucker, the umpire. Glad I'm not in there.
Well, it's probably too tight to call it, and therefore it'll be not out, but it's right on the line. I think the other shot gives us a better look at it, but He was cruising, Dyke. He wasn't busting to the line, and here you'll see he's got to have a part of the bat behind the line when the bail lifts, and gee, it's really, really tight.
It's going to be a tough one to give that, but I tell you what, I've got the feeling he may well have been on the line when that bail was dislodged. I reckon the bail is out there, and I reckon he's on the line. I thought he was absolutely cruising, and maybe he was.
Good to see Sean Tate charging back to get behind the stumps too. Just turning around and looking at their big Tate. But I'm with you, Tubb. I think that is out technically, but I wonder if the third umpire will give it.
Well, they don't normally take this long in the 2020 matches. Usually one quick look and then they'll make a decision. But obviously this one really is close. And the third umpire's had quite a long look at this. And now Michael Dighton, all of a sudden he looks worried. He wasn't worried while he was running, but now he's worried by the delay. With very good reason, I'd suggest. Decision pending now up on the screen, so we're going to get a decision very shortly. He's out, yes, given out. That's a big breakthrough for the Australians. Straight from Mike Hussey, you can see he's gone straight over to Xavier Doherty, who was the fieldsman. So they've got both the openers in the same over. So Dighton goes for 34. The All-Stars now 2 for 72.
Come on down to Bunnings to get your barbecues, your gas bottles or anything else. They're always at the lowest prices, we guarantee that.
Four-burner barbecue, $199. Ryobi Impact Drill, $46. Folding Lounge, $49. Laser Light Roofing, just $13.95 per metre. If you happen to find a cheaper price on a stocked item, we'll beat it by 10%.
I know how to fire up a barbie and cook up a good feast, yeah.
Bunnings Warehouse! Lowest prices are just the beginning.
Enjoying themselves here at the Gabba. Beautiful night for cricket. And a really good start to the season. The ACA, the Australian Cricketers Association, All-Stars, 2 for 72 after 5.4 over. Simon Kadich, the new man. Sean Tate steaming into Brad Hodge.
Yeah, and Simon Kadich, one of the stars of the Indian Tour, I thought. He's taken an opportunity there. Phil Jakes unfortunately missed the first test, then he returned home with a back problem. And have another look at this run out. Now, Dighton, to me, he's just maybe backed off right at the end. He went hard for three quarters of the single, and then he backed off. Doherty, bang on target, and on the line is out. And that's the angle that gives it up.
Oh, it's a no ball. It's been a good over. Well, the Australians, apart from that delivery, that'll be a free hit now for Brad Hodge.
It will, but I've been very impressed with Sean Tate. He's bowled with good pace and outside of about his first four balls, good control. There's the Kadich is going to be interesting. You're not necessarily thinking that he's a 2020 player, but there are Tate's numbers and they're good.
Oh, it's well taken from Brad Haddon, but he can't be out on the free hit. I think he's hit that too. Just flick the top edge. It's a brilliant take from Haddon and it counts for nothing. 2 for 73.
Overhold your head this way and bustle to the front of the line. As if they catch your eyes before you get inside, we'll never be allowed. But if you're feeling that way now, or if you ever feel so inclined, skip out the doors of boring 40 summers and rise.
Pack more into life in the Lancer Sportback, the all-new hatch. Love that car.
8 fours and 4 sixes in 6 overs. What a terrific start. Great entertainment for the crowd that's come along tonight. For everyone at home watching this on high definition. Beautiful start to the season. Peter Siddle in... Well, only right at the start of his career for Australia. Now has the opportunity to impress the selectors.
I mentioned Simon Kadich before, Slats. I'm interested to see him in this format. He had a terrific tour of India. He's spot on, and it's great to see because he's a ripper bloke and a really good player, and we all love seeing him playing well. Not necessarily the game that you would associate with the 2020 format.
No, but the crazy thing was, when he was finally dropped from the Australian side, he'd already been dropped from the test side. He was still playing one-day cricket. and then he got dropped from the one-day side. It was almost like initially they'd got it the wrong way around, the selectors. He should have been playing test cricket, maybe not one-day cricket, but I think now he's got the all-round game to suit all forms, and there's no doubt the current player wants to play 2020 cricket really well. And the nature of the beast is if you're playing 2020 cricket, I think that's going to help your 50-over cricket as a batsman. And I just find it phenomenal how this 2020 format has taken the cricketing world by storm. And what was it, a couple of weeks ago, that game in Antigua? $20 million, winner take all. The West Indies won it. Unbelievable stuff.
Yeah, they won it by 10 wickets, chasing 99. Thanks very much. Some guys only fielded about three balls for the day. Oh, that's out. Peter Siddle's got a wicket. Brad Haddin's got a catch. And that will delight Peter Siddle in the Australian side. Good healthy edge, good carry through to the keeper. That's what you want to see from your quick bowlers. Kadich goes early, 3 for 75, the A's.
Spicy.
KFC's hot and spicy crunch meal packs a real punch. With six delicious fiery fillets, crunchy crispy strips, wicked wings, and all your favourite sides. Bring back dinner with KFC's hot and spicy crunch meal.
Can't beat that beast.
Daniel Marsh is the new man for the All-Stars. 35 years old, another Tasmanian. An excellent year last year. The 50-over game, they won the Ford Ranger Cup. That's why you see a lot of the Tasmanians in this side. Dighton, Brett Jeeves in the Australian side, now Dan Marsh. All of a sudden, things have turned around.
I'll tell you what, he'll hope those 35-year-old eyes are tuned in because it's zinging around here at the moment. This guy, Siddle's really got it slapping into the gloves. Tate, if he continues, we know all about. He'll need to be spot on straight away, Dan Marsh.
Boy, so should Brad Haddin. He's done well to probably keep that to one. It'll be a wide, and so that'll be two wides, actually. But that swung a lot after it bounced.
Just testing out the bouncer in 2020. Who said I can't bowl a bouncer in this form of the game? Yeah, wide, but I'm getting stuck into Dan Marsh's first delivery. Here it is. Jeez, it was short.
Yeah, well, bear in mind that Peter Siddle's just been in India for about, 7 weeks. He'd been bowling that short to get them up about chest height in India. That one here at the Gabba goes sailing over the keeper's head. Cost him two runs.
Oh, this is impressive. I've seen a lot of Peter Siddle bowl live, but that is really nice areas and really good pace. And you tuck that in with what we saw from Tate. Fast bowling stocks in this country. You think about a succession land for some really good players like Lee and Clark. Plenty to enjoy from these two.
Well, actually, it is a bit of an opportunity, isn't it, for Peter Siddle? He's in the 13, the Australian Test match side, which the Test match starts here next Thursday. So he's trying to impress out there. That's a nice shot from Hodges. There'll be a sweeping man who'll probably keep it to two. Siddle is showing he's got pace, and when he gets the length right, the ball carries through beautifully to the keeper.
Yeah, and turning up today, I thought, are these guys going to go 100%? And the answer is yes. There's a lot to play for. Siddle, that's a terrific delivery. Got to Haddin, a nice height. And it's been interesting to note that Matthew Hayden said he felt the pitch is probably a little up and down. Gilchrist was saying the ball occasionally just feeling like it was sitting in the pitch a bit, meaning it just holds up.
Oh, that hasn't held up. That's raced away to the cover boundary. That is Brad Hodge at his absolute best. 3 for 83.
There are many lessons to learn in the outback.
Look how tall he is.
Like, never trust a kangaroo.
A kangaroo has $50,000.
And nothing happened.
Kangaroo Jack, Saturday 7:30 on WIN.
Charging you with murder, Horatio. You're being extradited to Brazil.
Will this be the big CSI moment?
Go free to law.
Where Horatio won't make it out alive.
An all-new CSI Miami returns Sunday.
In the
the dugout with Alfie. Alfie, any nerves, mate, because the boys have got it going through.
I've got to say, when you agree to this sort of thing, it seems like a good idea at the time. Having just watched Tatey bowl, I'm very, very, very happy to see Xavier Doherty's just about to come on to bowl.
Now, this is when Justin Langer puts his gloves on and gets ready. You'll be keeping this run rate going, mate, won't you? 3 for 83 off 7, no problems.
Yeah, being a great block artist like myself, it should be no worries getting up to 13 and over, but give it a crack, eh?
You are an idiot for being here, actually. But what are the plans? What were the plans when your team went out to bat?
Well, Michael Dighton showed us the plans. We'll just swing at every ball and hopefully it comes off. You know, it looks magnificent here at the Gabba. It's sort of bouncy, but hopefully I'll be able to swing a few and then get out and enjoy myself.
Yeah, and I reckon your bowlers might catch the Aussies on the hop too by the look of the bounce of this Gabba. And the spinner has got a wicket. Good luck, Alfie.
I'm in.
It's back to you, Slats.
There's the fourth wicket down. The All-Stars got off to a rocketing start and they've just fallen away a little bit in the past couple of hours. So Xavier Doherty has got a fortunate one there. Inside edge, back onto the stumps. Dan Marsh not troubling the scorers. That was a golden duck. And it's 4 for 83 now. Well, I've been able to boot Mark Taylor and James Brayshaw out of the commentary chairs. Bill Laurie and Mark Nicholas are in there now.
Yes, that's it. What a great turnaround here. 1 for 67. And all of a sudden it's 4 for 83. And a great bowling change that. Brought the spinner on just at the right time. It was just a little bit of turn. Nice fight. A little bit of inside edge. And great player. What a tremendous player Justin Langer has been in all forms of the game. He's going to be under a bit of pressure here. There was quick wickets. Marsh gone for duck. Cattage for one. Hodges on 12. So the KFC Australians are amongst the chickens at the moment, really doing well.
4 for 16 they've lost, Bill. Incredible first couple of overs. Michael Dighton just set the world alight. The Gabba, a crowd that are still filtering in, were straight up out of their chairs, cheering on the sixes, the hard hit boundaries, and then Gilly got involved. But unfortunately, they've lost their way a little bit. 4 for 83, a little bit of a rebuild. But in 2020, Mark, there's not any time to rebuild.
Well, they want to watch it, these All-Stars. They can be all out. I mean, they've got a problem because ever since, it's like so often happens in this game, you get a little bit of bad luck. And I think that Dighton's run out was bad luck. I think a lot of third umpires would have given that in. And it's changed the whole momentum of the game. And suddenly it's with the Australians. This is a good bowling change. This guy's bowling nice and slow.
And good fight too. Had Tate bowling at about 145 to 150 k's. Doherty comes on, throws it up, gets an inside edge. A little bit of turn. Marsh has gone for a duck. All of a sudden the pressure on. Hodge coming off 100 at the MCG on Wednesday. And Dighton, who scored 95, was in superb form early on. Struck the ball beautifully here against genuine pace. Doherty. Full pitch. Swung away, but just a single. Cameron White. Doherty. A little bit of turn. Inside edge. A bit unlucky when you haven't scored to get an inside edge. Big gap there between bat and tag. Took the stumps.
Just a tad lazy, wasn't he? He was just trying to ease it into the offside for a single.
Ask the question for LB. Good opportunity here for Doherty. He's been around a long time and a great servant for Tasmania.
Huss, Mark Nicholas here.
G'day, Mark. How are you, mate?
Yeah, I'm good. Spins the thing.
Pardon?
Spins the thing,
isn't
it?
He's doing a good job, is he?
Oh, fantastic.
First opportunity for Australia in there. We needed it, I tell you, after Dighton's onslaught at the start.
I know, that was a good break for you. I don't think any of you thought it was out, did you?
Oh, I hope it's his night tonight, Doherty. Run him out in a couple of wickets. Oh, no, it's a good shot.
Huss, you boys look to be very with it, very enthusiastic. Fun to be back, huh?
It's great to be home on Australian soil, I can tell you.
And playing on something with a bit of bounce and a bit of carry.
Oh, the bowlers in particular will be really enjoying it, I reckon. No, stay back. Stay back. Yeah, no, it's fantastic. It's great ground here. What a place to play cricket.
I know,
Oh!
I'll tell you what, Huss, we'll come back to you. It's 4-4-89 just.
Overhold your head this way and bustle to the front of the line, as if they catch your eyes before you get inside. We'll never be allowed. But if you feel that way now, or if you ever feel so inclined, skip past the doors of 40 summers and rise. So, and if you want to lose your frown, or your name or even your face,
pack more into life in the Lancer Sportback, the all-new hatch. Love that car.
Run rate 11.13. Bowling change. Members in. Andrew Simons. He'll be a little bit nervous. Big comeback for him. Tremendous athlete. Great entertainer.
Yeah, definitely. I think it's a fair point. I think more nervous than if he'd been in the All-Stars side. I think being ticked in an Australian shirt is just that little bit extra for him. I think the beauty of Dighton's innings was that he played so freely, as if he had nothing to lose. It was a one-off opportunity. So if you've just switched on, we saw an amazing innings. 34 from just 13 balls faced. And just Michael Dighton just nailed it. There aren't many people in history can outbat Adam Gilchrist, even though he hasn't played since, whatever it was, April or something like that. But it was an unbelievable assault.
Just a wanger in the air, but safe. Coming back for the second, that's good running.
Huss, just one other thing to ask you. Are you still there?
Yes, mate.
The run out, I don't think any of the guys thought it was out, did they?
No, well, to be honest, I was too worried about who was going to bowl next and all that sort of stuff. So I was very, very thankful when I could hear you blokes saying they think it's on the line. So it was, very handy dismissal for us.
This 2020 captaincy is a brainstormer, isn't it?
Well, I don't think there's too much I could have done at the start. It was amazing. Well, that's a good shot.
That's gone all the way. That's a big one. He's back. Justin Langer tricks it up and hits it way over mid-wicket. A long boundary two and well struck.
Well, he was talking with Ian Healy and talking about being a blocker no longer. Those last 5 years of his career, played all the shots in the book, and he can be a powerhouse as well.
Maybe two here. Just the single.
Worth remembering that Justin Langer comes off the back of a very good season for Somerset, playing in first-class cricket in England. So he has had some cricket behind him, and Somerset very nearly pulled off at the county championship under his leadership. He opened the batting with Marcus Roscothick, and they had a terrific time. But he's going back for more punishment next year, he says. One more season before I finally hang up the boots.
Wide call.
Well, it's quite strange, isn't it? You don't see it too often in Australia. He's retired from first-class ranks here in Australia. He's not playing any domestic cricket, and yet he's playing for Somerset. Yes, one more season. His stats are phenomenal in terms of the number of first-class runs, and he's going to have some fun tonight as well. 4 for 100.
Spicy.
KFC's hot and spicy kebab packs a real punch. With a fiery fillet, supercharged sauce, and your favourite kebab ingredients. KFC's hot and spicy kebab.
Can't beat that beast.
First delivery, just through that time by Doherty. Johnny Walker, All Stars, 4 for 100 in the 10th over. Opportunity here for Brad Hodge, breaking all the records for Victoria with the Bush Rangers. Tremendous batsman in all forms of the game, and he'll just chip the ball around here, give as much strike as he can to his partners, and he hold this innings together.
Oh. Nicely bowled there by Doherty, just sort of pushing that one a little quicker. It was inside edge from Brad Hodge. Talk about the form of Langer in England in county cricket and all the one-day stuff they play over there. And that's where the 2020 started, only a matter of years ago. He was introduced to English domestic scene and very quickly got the crowds back to domestic cricket over there, and it's just been the launching pad for the rest of the world.
These are important overs. Stoudy doing a good job, not conceding boundaries, changing his pace, that's slower, just enticing the sweep shot.
And a lot of the best stuff that we've seen tonight has been orthodox cricket, if you think of the ball Brett Sean Tate bowled out Adam Gilchrist with, the in-swinger, the full in-swinger, a classic ball of its type. Some of the strokes played by Michael Dyke, the straight hits, superlative. Adam Gilchrist, we know all about him. Justin Langer's six just now. Basically, the purest strikers of the ball tend to do it in an orthodox manner because that's what works with this game.
Attempted reverse sweep. 10 overs gone, 4 for 104.
Overhold your head this way and bustle to the front of the line. As if they catch your eyes before you get inside, we'll never be allowed. But if you're that way now, or if you ever feel so inclined, skip past the doors of boring for summers and rise. So, and if you want to lose your frown, or your name or even your face,
pack more into life in the Lancer Sportback, the all-new hatch. Love that car.
Andrew Simons bowls, pushes it down the leg side. There'll be buys here. Outfield fast, goes all the way. In fact, he gave his runs bottom edge. Valuable boundary here. They need some boundaries here, the All-Stars. Just tie down a fraction.
Yeah, partnership here, but it's always got to be in a fair clip. This one ill-directed by Andrew Simons, and an under-edge tickle there, running fine enough for the boundary. Again, just sort of getting too tight on that leg stump. Gets away with it this time.
Tell you what, the crowd's built up, you know. We've got a lot of people in this ground now. It's one of those stadiums where you don't necessarily realise how many are here. But not only is the crowd built up, a lot of young people are in the ground. And that's sort of the point Michael Slater was making about the speed at which this game has spread and attracted a new audience without necessarily dismissing the old audience. Fabulous, a great atmosphere out there. And people are really turned on by it.
I think Richie Beno got it right on Sunday on Widewater Sports. He said, this is the form of the game where the kids bring the parents to it. Whereas the longer form is the parents taking the kids to it. And I think he nailed it. The kids love it.
Fancy Mr. Beno getting it right.
Yeah. No great surprise there at all, is there? Another little piece of gold.
It's a handy over this. It's the one boundary. And the All-Stars need to push on here. The over's ticking by. Gets through, I pick up two. It's 4 for 112.
Building a brand new heart.
Yes.
On 60 Minutes. Human spare parts made to order.
We can build it.
Also, the biggest Aussie movie of all time.
Make this look sexy.
60 Minutes, Sunday.
No deposit, no interest, no repayments till 2010 at Harvey Norman now. Now's the time to update, upgrade, upsize. The best of the latest in lounges, dining and outdoor furniture. On no deposit, no interest, no repayments till 2010. 15 months interest free at Harvey Norman now.
Go!
4 for 112 off 11 with Adam Gilchrist and Gilly. Everything just seemed fast out there. How did it feel?
It's crazy. From Dighton's first ball that he faced for six, reminded me a bit of your debut. My recollection of my debut, everything did seem fast and big and loud, and it just sort of disappears before you know it. So it was like that for me again today.
Was there anything, as we see Dave Hussey coming on the bowl and just worked, nearly a run-out chance again too. Did you pick up anything not working between Jeeves and Dighton, teammates? And Dighton just went for him, didn't he?
He did. The ball just seemed to be holding in the wicket a little bit and allowing Dighton to sort of swing through freely. I think Tate adjusted his length well eventually. Maybe Jeezy just stayed back of a length a bit too much.
It's that poor moustache, I reckon. It's not a good look, Jeevesy, at the moment, but it's all for charity. This is a wonderful cause that the game is for and the gesture that every player tonight is making for cricket.
Yeah, particularly these guys that have been in the subcontinent for 8 weeks or whatever it was to have a day or a night at home and then come up and be a part of this. It's a wonderful account by them to be here and, as you say, good support. Hopefully an annual event, nice way also to launch the summer on Nine and for Cricket Australia.
Now, you didn't show any signs of rust, mate. How did it feel for yourself?
I didn't feel very comfortable. As I said on air, I did have a hit before the game. It's my first one for 6 months, and I started cramping up out there in the first over. So I need to work on my fitness, I think.
Oh, I bet you don't, though.
No, that's right. I won't.
Thanks again, Gilly.
Cheers.
Back to you, boys.
Thanks, Heels. The great Adam Gilchrist. Meanwhile, his side ticks along here. This is his partnership of 31 off 28. They've steadied the ship a fraction. They need a boundary or two. This man on screen is a fine cricketer, David Hussey. One of the best strikers of the ball in the country, and he'll be sensational later on tonight if he gets a start. Beautiful striker of the ball. Hits it long and hard.
One of the Australians that make a big impact in the IPL. Highly priced player. A number of Australians. Shane Watson was another. Sean Marsh. Michael Hussey, of course, though more briefly, but this guy's very highly thought of over in India.
So over bowled. 4 for 114.
Hot and spicy.
KFC's Hot and Spicy Crunch Meal packs a real punch. With six delicious fiery fillets, crunchy crispy strips, wicked wings, and all your favourite sides. Bring back dinner with KFC's Hot and Spicy Crunch Meal. Can't beat that
beast. 4 for 114, a tremendous night. Warm, good crowd in. Good start by the All-Stars. Be looking at 170 to 200 if they can fire up. There were 73 after six, so the Australian 11, the KFC Australian 11, have pegged them back slightly. It's gone for it. What a good thick edge and flies over cover. Siddle, very impressive. Sharp, good line, some swing.
And Victorian, Bill. The Victorian, he'd be flying after that tour of India. He made his debut, got that one test match, and I thought he did well. They could have gone one of two ways. There was Dougie Bollinger waiting, the left armer from New South Wales, had taken 40-odd plus wickets last summer for the Blues. But Siddle was picked, and I thought he bowled quite nicely throughout that test match. So he's right at the start of his career.
He was a bit stiff too, caught and bowled. He's a good athlete, a big fast bowler. He's a wood chopper from Morwell. Could have been a champion wood chopper. Comes from a wood chopping family, and I wouldn't tap him on the shoulder in a dark night, Mark, either.
No, I know what you mean. Have a look at this. That is a phenomenal reaction, almost as good as that. And oh, that. Now that ball was drilled back at him. He made a great debut. First test wicket, Sachin Tendulkar, something he'll share with Cameron White for the rest of his life. Both of them got Tendulkar before they got anybody else.
Whoa, there she goes. That'll be four wides. Quick. 141 Ks. Too short. Too wide.
Not a bad first wicket, is it? Sachin Tendulkar. This occasion, though, just getting a little bit carried away with the short of a good length. This is it. A bit shorter than that. We saw that Jeeves found this problem bowling from the same end as well. Just see there, the ball just sort of did hit the pitch, sat in it, and then It's almost like it was spring-loaded, so the length's crucial.
At a length, well struck, but down to Andrew Symes. Symes, I thought, looked a little nervous tonight in the field. I'm a great bat for Andrew Symes. I think he's a great entertainer, one of the best fields we've ever seen. A tremendous strike with the ball, and he's under a lot of pressure. So it's a big occasion for him tonight. So a lot of media coverage. Dyke, and boy, was he on fire. 95 against the Vicks at the MCG. You can't hit any better than that. Straight and long and high.
Last one was the best of the lot. He was cruelly unlucky to get run out this evening. There wasn't even a centimetre in it. I mean, a lot of umpires wouldn't have given him. It was a fantastic start to the evening. And that partnership with Adam Gilchrist, I mean, it set the place alight. It made the fireworks look like an anti-climax.
Got himself to blame now. He's very casual in the last strike too. Watch this. He doesn't really stretch at all with the bat. He just sort of ambles in with a little bit of a push forward. A little bit stiff, I thought.
Xavier Doty, another a teammate of his. He probably thought, oh, this bloke can't throw. I'll see him at practice. Played with him.
Knocked the stumps out. Looks like Troy Cooley's brother.
That's well hit. That's going long, long, long. It's gone. That's one of the biggest hits of the night.
That is a huge boundary. The pitch is set on the opposite side of the square, and it didn't go into the crowd, but nearly. That is a monster.
You can tell after he's hit it. Watch him. He never moves. He never moves a muscle. We don't pick him up on that one, but he never moves. He just watches it sail.
That's that one that you hit and you just go, boy, I've got a good taste of it.
Puts into perspective Brett Lee's hit here when he hit one over the roof.
It's doing well. 13 gone, 4 for 131.
Trying to find that special item this week? It pays to shop at your local IGA supermarket. Sorbent Gold Toilet Tissue 4-pack, 2 for $4. Raid Fly Spray, 2 for $6. Grab these specials and more when you shop with someone you know this week at IGA, your town, your store.
Put your feet up and make yourself more comfortable than you ever imagined. Beat the price rise on Stressless during the November Norwegian promotion. It's time to take the comfort test. Stressless at Euphoria.
Bob Kleine's been in tremendous form for the Bushrangers, so has McDonald. So there's plenty of batting to come. Andrew Symes. Brad Hodge on strike. Sweeps and sweeps well, but just the single. What's a good score, Mark?
350.
We thought it was going to be 350 by the way it started. It's just come back a tad.
It's not India batting out there. Well done, but just not quite timed.
This...
You've got to go at 10 and over, haven't you? Got to. So it's got to be 200. Don't you think?
Yeah, I think to be competitive, just having a look at the pitch, 180, 180 plus. Somewhere between 180 and 200, the All-Stars have got something to bowl at. Knowing that you can get those 3 to 4 wickets very quickly, as we've seen in this innings. It was 4 for 16, and now there's a partnership building again. It's 50 from 38.
I wonder if the All-Stars will learn something about length, because there's no doubt, I know they've enjoyed it, but Australia have erred on the short side, and that's where a lot of the All-Stars runs have been scored. Not the Dighton assault so much, but most of the rest of the runs. Off short balls.
The last couple of deliveries, Bill, Andrew Symes has taken everything off the ball in terms of pace. The last couple have been around 80 kilometres an hour. He'd probably push them in mid-80s to high 80s, but he's just trying to take all the pace off it.
Well, he got what he deserved there. It's going to go all the way again. Long hit. One bounce, two bounces. Langer doing well. It looks to me as if he'd rather be fishing at the moment. He's all over the place. He's short.
Steady,
and he's
Bill.
Full.
I hope he didn't hear that.
Oh, through him. That'll be four byes or was inside edge. Four buys, 11 off the over, 14 gone, 4 for 142.
Here's something to celebrate. It's the 40 Winks Explosive Bedroom Clearance. Stock dramatically reduced to clear. One-off items, once-only bargains, discontinued lines at over 90 stores Australia-wide. Beds and bedroom furniture, mattresses, bases, bedside tables, dressers, tall boys. Furnish your whole bedroom with these explosive reductions. Bring cash and credit card only. Get everything for your bedroom at the 40 Winks Explosive Bedroom Clearance. When it's gone, it's gone. Hurry to 40 Winks. End Sunday.
Changing commentary team as James Brayshaw and Mark Taylor joins Mark Nicholls.
Thanks, Bill. 4 for 142. This Sean Tate really liked what we saw earlier. James Brayshaw gave him a rap and made a lot of points about the X factor that he's got and how Australian cricket has just got to look after him. We didn't pick up on the fact that he'd be nervous too. This is a big occasion for him to be back amongst it with all the named players in Australia after his difficult period. It's not just Simons who's back from rehab.
Yeah, once again, Brad Hodge also doing a really good job. Every time he plays in some sort of representative match, if that's the way to put it, whether it's playing for Australia or an All-Stars team, he seems to do well. And yet he's one of those guys that just, you know, seems to be easy to leave out. He seems to be the first guy out of a team. So 40 now from 31 balls faced.
He's off the back of 100 the other day, so he feels in good nick. He could have gone second ball if there'd been a second slip in place. And second slip could have held on because it flew at a delivery bolt at about 152 Ks. He'd have gone second ball. That was when Tate had just got Gilchrist and was flying in. This looks like sort of medium pace fare in comparison.
See what he's doing, and there's lots of talk about it, Nico, and that is he's clearing that left hip. And that gives you that arm room to really get an aggressive bat swing at the ball. And I know that in county cricket they're starting to do it a lot, and he's a good exponent of it.
Always got away with that one. An inside edge. And well, I think we've got Andrew Simons back. We actually lost him there for a while.
Stay there.
Simo, 4 for 145. These five and a half overs to go. How's it looking?
Yeah, it's looking good. I got a little stand-up, mate. You're on. I've got to talk to Tubby, and you've got to feel
at least give
ball.
Him your hat. At least give him a hat to wear. Mate.
If he hits it down here, mate, you're on, right? Get ready. Sorry, mate.
At least give him your hat.
Try and hide him a bit, you reckon?
I'm not sure he's got the same haircut as you, but at least give him your hat. Put a hat on him, mate. Now, that looks better. Now he looks like an Australian cricketer.
He can have one more than you can go, mate, right?
There is the most nervous person on the planet.
How you going there?
Imagine if the ball comes to him.
What's your name, mate?
Tom.
Tom's on.
Simo, can you talk to him? How's he feeling, mate? Is he a bit nervous?
Yeah, talking to him, mate. Mark Taylor wants to know how you going.
Good, thanks.
Are you nervous, Tom?
He's nervous.
Are you nervous? Ask him if he's nervous or not, Simo.
How nervous are you?
Pretty nervous.
OK, get ready. Here you go.
Oh, that could be a no ball, that. It is a no ball. No, I think it was above waist height. I reckon that's a pretty good call from Bruce Oxenford. It was a full pitch ball, and anything above the waist should be called a no ball. And I reckon the umpire's got it dead right.
There's Tommy, just hurling the ball in. I reckon for a second, when that came off Justin Langer's bat, Tom's heart jumped into his mouth because he thought he might have got a good enough piece of it to hit it right down his throat.
Can you imagine if Tommy's under a sky and catches it?
What's your name, mate?
Well, I think Tom's had his
Tom's down here.
Another Tom has come on to the field. He doesn't look nervous at all, this one. He's very relaxed. What about the footwear? What's he got on?
He's got the
beach gear.
Yeah, how you going, mate? They want to know if you're nervous or not. A little bit nervous. Yeah, I think he's going better than the other Tom. The other Tom was nervous. He seems to be holding his nerve a bit better.
Oh,
later on.
Oh, that's nicely hit. Here we go. Go, Tom.
Oh,
oh
Tom,
no, he's missed it. He's missed it. He needs a few more lessons, I think. Big throw, Tom. Let it go. Not bad at all.
Nicky Siddle is absolutely spearing it, mate. Thanks, mate.
One Tom gets a chance to field, and I think Andrew Simon said that Peter Siddle's probably the only man who's not happy. That's cost him an extra run off his bowling.
It's a bit too late to worry. He's gone for 50. That's fantastic television, isn't it? Look at this. Oh! He'll bring his boots next time, because you never know, do you?
Obviously, he hasn't done too much training with the Australian side. That's part of the parcel of fielding in the deep. He wasn't ready for that, was he?
Tell you what, though, his mum and dad will be asking for the DVD. They'll tuck that away forever, those two boys.
Righto, back to the game. It's 10 and over. So, it's looking very good for 200, aren't they? You feel that's what they're going to need on this pitch. The pitch is quick. It's good carrying. The outfield's also quick. There's plenty of, obviously, good batting in the Australian side to come. So, I reckon around about 200's certainly chaseable.
Look at the bat. You see the bat? You see the thickness of the bat? How differently they're made? And now there's talk of a two-sided bat. So switch hitting will take on a whole new meaning. The game, the 2020 game, will change an awful lot of cricket. There's no doubt about that. Not just perceptions and tactics, but it'll change the mechanics of the game too.
He's got that away, Justin Langer. Two more. I'm not actually sure what happened to Xavier Doherty then, when he was bowling that ball. It looked to me like he lost his run-up.
Got a bit of a stutter up.
Or is that a tactic because he thinks Langer's going to move? So he wants to have a look.
That's pretty well placed from Justin Langer. He's just chipping the ball away between the sort of deep mid-on and deep mid-wicket. Doing it really well at the moment, picking up two every time.
Talk about the bats, Nico. They're made to last about 3 months. There we go. That is a total loss of run-up or a tactic. Not sure. But yeah, they do no rolling of them. They just get beautiful access to the best wood players at this level, and in 3 months' time it's gone, they get another one.
That's in the gap again. This one's better hit. Still won't go to the boundary.
You mean they don't oil their bat and sandpaper their bat, nurture their bat, and go to bed with their bat?
No. They get a quiver of about 10 of them. And they hit them until they're busted, and they pick out another one.
You got it.
And this one's all the way. Oh, no, it's not. It's still four. Sean Tate in the end's misjudged it. I thought when Justin Langer hit that, that was long enough. In the end, he got four. Probably should have been out. Four for 163.
We've got all the lights you're going to need to make your house look the best this Christmas. Christmas just isn't Christmas without Christmas lights.
10-piece party light set, only $19.97. Cabot's 4-litre decking oil, $53.90. Pressure cleaner, $99. Home light blower vac, $49. Mosquito lantern, just $13.48.
Come to our festive lighting workshop, Saturday 15th of November at 11 a.m. Bunnings
Warehouse. Lowest prices are just the beginning.
Well, the intrepid reporters found the two Toms. How was that, boys? Is Andrew Simons your favourite cricketer now? And maybe was he always?
Always. Probably always.
Very good. And what did it feel like on the Gabba with big crowd here behind you?
A bit nervous.
A bit nervous. And were you not ready, young Tom, for the flick from the other fielder?
No, none at all.
Now, what about you, boys? Do you play cricket tomorrow morning?
Yeah. Saturday and Sunday.
And who for?
West Nudgee.
And so you've got a massive story to tell the boys tomorrow. How are you going to start to explain this one?
No idea.
What about you?
No.
Just big note that you asked Andrew Simons for a bit of a go on the field and he gave it to you?
Yeah.
What about your footwear? Hey, no shoes on the Gabba during a massive match, Australia versus the All-Stars. You enjoying the night?
Yeah, definitely.
And what do you think is going to be a good score? 4 for 163. Do you think they need a little bit more, and will Australia get them?
I reckon Australia will get them.
Oh, very good. What about you, Tom?
Yeah, I think Australia will just get them by 1 wicket.
Very good. Well, from the two Toms, back to the commentary box. Thanks, boys.
Bye. What a night they've had, the two Toms. I would have loved that. I would love the interview too, I would have thought. They have something to talk about tomorrow in their game of maybe under-12s, or the younger Tom, probably under-8, something like that.
Do you think they'll swagger out at West Natchez and say, this is dull? I was at the Gabba last night.
Might swagger out without any shoes on, and the coach will say, where are your spikes?
Well, this time, Justin's got one. I thought he hit a 6 last over. This one's well back.
He's hitting them cleaner than he ever did when he was playing properly. Unbelievable. Right out of the middle of the bat. That's gone a mile.
Jeeves is back into the attack. I'm not sure he's having the greatest night. He's now gone for 44 from 2.3 overs. And I reckon that's at least 4 sixes gone from him. Actually, it's 5 off his bowling.
One change that definitely is coming into the game is that the batsmen are working out the slower ball. That was a slower ball from Jeeves, just cutting his fingers across it. Langer had picked it. And that's why you see much more variation in length. And certainly a lot of the quicker bowlers want to get 50% of balls through around chest high, mixing that up with the Yorkers, rather than just trying to bowl the Yorkers and the slower balls that have been the perceived way to go prior to now. And that is Maxima. Brad Hodge joins in the fun. Two old stages, you could call them, Hodge and Langer, and they are going for a big party here.
This is the technique in this game. You just clear that front hip and give yourself maximum swinging room, and wherever the ball is, there's Justin Langer's version of it. And then you'll see Brad Hodge there.
Oh, that's an even better shot. It's 2 less runs, but wow, that is right out of the middle. And that's 50 from only 37 balls for Hodge. Beautifully hit.
What a way to get there. It's 4 for 181.
Monday on the inspirational season final, meet an amazing family.
I love my kids.
Who truly deserve the full dream team experience.
Vic and Joanne, are you there?
In one of the biggest efforts yet.
It's absolutely enough.
The team perform another miracle makeover.
Do you like it?
Overwhelming.
We've saved the very best to last.
Oh my God!
Domestic Blitz season final, Monday 7:30 on Win.
4 for 181. The All-Stars, after winning the toss and batting, Xavier Doherty's got over number 18 to bowl. Both Langer and Hodge striking the ball beautifully. Just a single on this occasion. I'm sure everyone at home is enjoying this, particularly those who have their higher definition television on. The pictures are absolutely fantastic. We've got them here in the commentary box. Pictures are very clear. Brilliant to watch sporting.
The Emirates ladies are enjoying it. Not sure Brett Jeeves is. He's gone for 55 from his 3 overs. Brad Hodge is enjoying it. 53 from 37 balls. He's comfortably over 30. So is Justin Langer. They don't look it.
Who said it when he came out to bat, Brad Hodge? He doesn't look a lot older than when he started cricket, when he was about 21 for Victoria. That's well bowled, Doherty. He saw Brad Hodge advancing. He'll still get 2, though.
And this is a great story, Doherty, because this is a true surface, and he has bowled now 3.5 overs and gone for just 25 and taken a wicket.
David Hussey bowled 1 over for 2 and hasn't been asked to bowl again.
It's those figures you talk about are quite strange when you think that it's his brother who's captaining the side. Maybe there's some brotherly spat they've had between overs, 1 over for 2, and that'll do. You're bowling too well in this game.
is David Hussey. And there's his brother Michael in charge. He's going to want to bat well, as are his mates, because they're going to be chasing over 200. In fact, the way they're going, comfortably over 200.
I reckon Mike Hussey's forgotten about his brother. We've spent so much time with him over the years, and he's now forgotten about him. That's well bowled. Can he hit? And he gets home safely. Started extremely well, 17 from the first over. Michael Dighton hit 6 and a 4 from his first two balls he faced. That set the tone for the innings for the All-Stars, scoring around about 10 and a half runs per over.
They have played so well, this pair. I mean, they've put on over 100, and they've done it in quick time, and they've averted any danger of a collapse. It's 4 for 187.
This update is brought to you by MyState Financial, where we have a home loan for you, wherever you are in life.
Good evening, updating with news. Tasmania police are searching for two men involved in a brazen armed robbery in Hobart. David Bartlett calls for an inquiry into senior government appointments to write its final report. And the state government announces $22 million for patient transport. From the Wynn News team, good night.
So Langer 47 and Hodge 57. These two have added 104. Only 67 balls faced, and they've done it beautifully. I did feel at 4 for 83 that the Australians were getting back in the game, but now they will be chasing over 200. Brett Jeeves has one over to bowl. I'm not sure he really wants to bowl it. 3 overs 55.
Tell you what, that scorecard showed us. Look at the strike rates. Basically, on a good pitch, if you strike at 100, you're not going well enough. You've got to be scoring it a lot faster than a run of ball. And if you really fly, you can get to 160, and then you're hot property.
What it really does show you, doesn't it, that Michael Dighton's innings right at the top there. 34 from 13 balls. If you can get someone to start like that, in that explosive fashion. We're used to seeing Adam Gilchrist start in that way, but Dighton was the man today. 34, and that's only from two overs that he faced on his own. And that allows people like Hodge and then someone like Langer in the middle order to bat a little bit more sensibly.
Hodge has batted beautifully. He's played some scintillating shots. Shane Watson hasn't had a lot to do. He's been on and off the field, but at the moment he's got the best view in the house.
I think he's just having a breezer out. Breather. He bowled a lot of overs in India, and this whole thing's like a sort of cool breeze has drifted through the Australian team. How's that for a stop?
Slower ball again, and he got away with it. Justin Langer got a really good piece of it, but hit it straight back at him. And it was either stop or be hit.
I get the feeling that Brett Jeeves is going to have to find a new slower ball. I think every batsman seems to have picked it so far. That'll be a wide, that one.
What do they do with the last over, the Aussies? Sean Tate come on and bowl it. Keep with the finger spinner, who's done a really good job. Ballsy move.
Entertainment. This is about entertainment. Sean Tate must bowl the last over. Looking at that, it should be David Hussey.
Well, he's the one I'd like to see bowled. I'd like to see Mike Hussey walk up to him and say, bro, you've got the last over. Keep him under 200, will you?
I think he might hear some of the old backyard language if he went with that one. They travel different paths, those two.
It's nice to hit from Hodge. Boy, he hits the ball hard. He's only a small man, but he's strong. Once again, the slower ball goes for the boundary. 4 for 196. We've got an over to go.
Harvey Norman fires up barbecue deals for 4 days only. Scorching savings on all the top brands. Plus, bonus meat tray with every Barbie sold over $500. Plus, bonus gift card up to $100. Don't miss 4 days of hot barbecue deals ending this weekend.
Go!
1 in 5 Tasmanians chooses to sell their home with Roberts. 16 times as many as the average real estate agent. Call us when you're ready to sell, and we'll show you why.
And Hodge has raced to 63. 44 balls faced. And that's the last ball he faced. It was bowled at about 115 k's. And came off the bat at 132, we've been told. Mark Dickus, you got your way. Sean Tate's going to bowl the last over.
Good. I was just thinking about Brad Hodge, you know. He's done it in England for Leicestershire. He's done it here for Victoria. He consistently makes runs in one-day cricket, and he does it in a lovely, orthodox manner. He's the most underrated performer. It's odd he doesn't rate a mention more than he might, really, because he's played some stunning shots here. He hit one through extra cover all the way along the ground that almost did burn the grass. I mean, this lovely to watch.
Swing and a miss. I'll be interested to hear from the Australian captain tonight, Mike Hussey, who was, well, I suppose Ponty couldn't play and then Michael Clarke couldn't play, so Mike Hussey had to take over the captaincy. And how have you enjoyed it, Michael, and how did you get to Sean Tate as bowling this last over?
Well, I just had a chat to him, said what sort of field he wanted. He was pretty keen to have fine leg up and had the two straight guys back and... I don't know, just do what he does best and let him fly and see how we go. But, yeah, he's been pretty good tonight, Tatey. Shot.
And that's 50 for Langer. Might be a boundary. And we should get two. Things change for Justin Langer. Another 50 at the Gabba.
He's one of the most competitive people I've ever met, JL, and it doesn't surprise anyone that without a lot of cricket, although, obviously, he's played probably more than Gilly, but he's come out and done the job. 51 from 40 balls and played really well.
I'm not called a wide. Wouldn't have been that far from leg stump, wouldn't have thought.
Get the dictionary, look up the word competitive, and you'll find Justin Langer.
You wouldn't know it, Nico. You've got those blue eyes and they look like they're half asleep. But yeah, he's like a dog with a bone.
It's pretty well bowled from Sean Tate. He's firing the ball into the pads there of Justin Langer, giving him no room, as James Brayshaw said a couple of overs ago, to clear that front leg, play that big shot over mid-wicket. So final ball, 4 for 201. Well, they've made the 200 barrier, which is always an outstanding score. No matter where you're playing in 2020 cricket, 10 and over is never easy to get. This will be a great test for the Australians later this evening. Has he got enough on it? No, he hasn't. They'll look for two and they'll get it. Good last over from Sean Tate, but an excellent innings from the All-Stars, having won the toss, electing to bat first. They've scored it over 10 runs per over, 4 for 203. Terrific entertainment for everyone watching at the ground and at home. They've done it beautifully. Dighton started, really, with the very first two balls he faced. A 6 and a 4, made that cameo 34 from 13 balls. And then you saw Gilchrist, Hodge, and obviously Justin Langer do the most of the batting in those middle overs.
Yeah, the two veterans were terrific. There's the bowling. Jeeves, expensive take. Fantastic. Four overs for 28. Really fast. And after about the first four balls, lots of control. And Doherty also doing a terrific job. Simons and Hussey.
Well, the Australian All-Stars will be delighted with that score. And the Australians got it all to do. And I'll be interested to hear from some of the Australians how they think they're going to chase those run down, those runs down, should I say. 204 to get in their 20 overs. And I get the feeling there's Ian Healy down there. It looks like he's got the two former, well, one current Australian opener and one former one.
Yeah, Tubbs, thanks, mate. And look, they've had a little cuddle down here too. Albie made a 50. That's his first 50 for Australia and didn't get a little love in from Matty. Albie, very good, mate. Congratulations.
Yeah, it's good fun. It's not going to be the same as walking out on, was it Thursday or Friday for the test match, but it's good fun. It's a great place to bat, and it's just good to be playing cricket again.
Yeah, you haven't got too much time, Matty, because there's only a short changeover in these games. The ball that stands out for me is that nick off Tatey that went past the slips and hit the boards before I could see it. I'd hate to field that. How did it feel in slips?
Yeah, well, it was frightening, really is, because you don't really know where to stand for a start. Hads and I were very concerned after being about 8 or 9 yards closer to India, suddenly being thrust out into one of the fastest conditions in the world. It's pretty frightening.
And it's all good news for New Zealand, I suppose.
Absolutely.
As long as you blokes can get used to it.
Well, we've got to do our best now. We've got a huge total. Don't worry about New Zealand. We've got to beat these blokes.
10 and over, Alfie. You keep them under that?
Oh, yeah, we'll wait and see. We haven't got Tatey. Like I said, Tatey, that was express, wasn't it? So can we keep him under it? Yeah, we'll give it a crack.
He's playing pretty cool, Matty, but thanks very much. Lovely couple. Lovely couple. Back to you, boys.
Thanks, Ian. Thanks to Justin and to Matthew Hayden. Still plenty of competition between the two openers as well. Matthew Hayden very keen to win this match. Well, we're going to take a short break, but coming back after the break, we've got some more sensational live entertainment. We've got Natalie Bassingthwaite performing here live at the Gabba. Two songs from her new album, straight after this. That could be six, a long way back. That's why he's in this side. That's from one of his teammates. That's nice and played. He goes over cover. Oh, beautiful hit. Michael Dyer, left stranded. Hold it.
That was almost brilliant.
Hold it. Oh, that's out.
Peter Steele's got a wicket.
By the look of the bounce of this game,
the spinner has got a wicket.
It's going long, long, long. It's gone.
Than it was in some of those photos.
Well, I see the necklace in my little shot on the fifth when we got up that plane. I had the necklace on. That was the purchase of the tour, but it only lasted about 1 week when I got back to the bush. They didn't like it at all.
Just quickly, fellas, as the players go out, we know that those two Toms will have Andrew Simons as their hero. Who were your heroes when you grew up?
I used to like all the left-handers. Alan Border was one. I used to like Kepler Vessels, being an opening batsman. Kepler Vessels, but all the left-handers.
Two of them were in that photo of mine. John McLean, the Queensland wicketkeeper. Greg Chappell, the Australian elegant batsman, just like myself.
Thanks, fellas. Right, we're going to go upstairs now because waiting for us in the commentary box, James Brayshaw, Michael Slater and Bill Lurie.
Thank you, Mark. And a big total here, 204 the target. It's a big assignment, good pitch, fast outfield, but 10 runs per over. And the Johnny Walker All-Stars have done a very good job, and it does put pressure on Matthew Hayden and Sean Marsh at the crease now. Marsh, tremendous start to his international career. Tremendous strike of the ball, because Matthew Hayden, one of the all-time greats.
It's Bill Mark Taylor talking about his natural hair. How come it's got an orange tinge to it then, Slats? That's my question, but Bill is spot on. This man in screen here has got enormous talent. Very clean hitter of the ball, wonderful array of strokes, and an enormous future ahead of him. And there's a man who's had an enormous career. What a player Matthew Hayden's been. 37, hard to believe, still getting the job done.
In grand style as well. He was out of the game for a little while with an Achilles tendon problem, and as you get a bit older, you get a bit worried what your sort of recovery rate is, but he's back in some sort of flight now. It took him a while in India to get going, but he found form with that 70 odd in that final test match. Unfortunately, it wasn't enough, but the big fella, he's going strong.
Goffin to come into the attack, and Gilchrist with two slips, which is a good move. A bit of movement early on with the white ball. And that's a good start. Good carry to the keeper. Good genuine pace.
A lot to look forward to here. Sean Marsh, the real revelation of that IPL series in India, where he just kept getting better and better. Became almost the player of the tournament. Goffin already underway.
Well, that's well bowled too, some movement off the seam. Very good lineup, spanning lineup, plenty of depth. Watson, Simons, Michael Hussey, a tremendous striker of the ball, as is his brother. Cameron White, seven. Haddon, tremendous striker as well, so they've got plenty of depth.
We've got a hell of a game on our hands here. I'm thrilled that the All-Stars got 203. It gives the Australians a real challenge, a real target to chase, and they're going to have to chase it well.
Fraction too straight, a leg by, or maybe an inside edge. Leg by the call.
What also takes the shackles off the Australians, because to make 200, you just got to go and keep going. There's no point trying to plan anything. You're over 10 and over, so it is foot to the floor and keep it there. That is a terrific performance. Hodge was great. Dighton off the top was great, and the two stars, Gilchrist and Langer, also.
Brad Hodge, always consistent. I thought Dighton's start was fantastic. It's not easy to hit the bowler back over his head, a genuine pace. Unfortunately, run out. So Hodge and Langer did the job. Big target. Hayden goes, struck on the body. Good line, good pace.
Good to see he's going to play himself in tonight, Matthew Hayden. First ball, McGoffin, tall. He's got an appearance of Glenn McGrath, hasn't he, McGoffin? He's tall and slender. Quite a different action, but with that height, he's going to get the bounce. And Haydos trying to squash it to the onside.
Got away nicely. It's the fraction too straight. Brings up the first boundary. That's well played. Very strong off his pads. Big, strong man, Matthew Hayden. McLaughlin's aware that was too straight. It's good left-hander. That's fruit for the sideboard.
He's been a dominant player in all forms of the game now for a long time, Matthew Hayden. Huge man, the big unit. And he's taken aggressive opening batting to a new level in all forms of the game, even Test cricket. He walks at bowlers and dictates the terms. This game's just made for him.
There it goes, could be out, should be out. Midoff getting around, high ball, will it be taken? Nervous catch, yes, he's got it, that's a big wicket. Harris takes the catch, Hayden's gone, it's 1 for 5 at the Gabba.
I thought I was high up in the stand when Natalie Bassingthwaite was singing, but that's gone a million miles.
The opening of our new Burnie dealership now makes us truly statewide, with locations in each major city. With finance now at just 9.9%, fixed for up to 7 years, you can choose from 6 new car franchises and a selection of over 1,000 cars. And it just gets better. For November, if you purchase a used car over $5,000, I'll throw in a brand new 42-inch plasma TV. Visit us at Jackson Motor Company, jmc.com.au.
The ball comes in under pressure, and 1 for 5. KFC Australian 11, chasing 204. This is a very high ball, and that's a tough catch.
High? How high has it gone? That is a remarkable catch. To sit under that, you have that many thoughts running through your head. It keeps drifting back a little bit, so you're correcting. He took it beautifully in the end. Matthew Hayden, he was out there, and he was going to play shots. That third ball he faced, and, yep, he's out of there for sure. What a catch.
Ryan Harris was the player parked underneath it. Former South Australian, now up here. And that is terrific cricket. He would have been nervous parked under that. knowing it was Matthew Hayden who'd hit the ball a mile in the air, took it very well.
Brendan Drew from the members end. Outswing, but wide.
He's coming from the Vulture Street end, and that was a banana. That started just a little bit wide of off stump, but really hooped through the air. And at times, if you can get the white ball going, it'll go a long way. Positive sign, even though it's a wide, if you can get it on target, off and middle, and swing away from there, that's a dangerous delivery.
Stein down the leg side, another wide.
Well, they'll be nervous, these blokes. They're on the national stage, getting comfortable playing for their states and doing it really well. Otherwise, they wouldn't have been picked to play in these games. But both McGoffin and Drew be very nervous bowling to the best players in the country, best players in the world, in Hayden, Simons and Hussey. And the nerves and the heart will be pumping. Ryan Harris, big opportunity for him.
Good pace and good line.
The one thing that's happening out there now, JB, is they can sniff at the All-Stars, can't they? They've got that one wicket, the big wicket of Hayden. Sean Marshall, they can't underestimate him. He is a powerhouse with a bat, and he's just come of age so quickly. And that IPL that gets interesting press at times, the Indian Premier League, has been the launching pad for him. This youngster now is away, but the All-Stars can feel that they can put some pressure on the Australians, but that is one of the most technically correct straight drives you'll ever see, Bill.
Just going to say, we've seen some magnificent hitting tonight, but no better strokes than that one. Brad Hodge played one glorious cup drive as well that comes to mind, but when you just come to the crease and you lost an early wicket, you get a good length delivery, the little movement about, and that's beautifully played by Shane Watson. Controlled, but still a big boundary for him. And his side. Tommy swings it away. He's torn it back by Tony Greig with that stance. Goodness sake, give that away.
Reckon Greggy's tuning in. Still in India, is he? He's saying, well, I tell you, Bill, that's not all.
That's a beautiful piece of batting, no matter how you hold your bat. It's the maker's name. You can get behind in the count very quickly in this form of the game. 200 is a big target. And it can't afford a slow start. You put enormous pressure on the middle and late order.
Sean Marsh. Oh, well struck. Beautifully controlled shot. Gets him off the mark. Probably pick up three here. He showed he's got a touch of class. Marsh already in his short career with the way he places the ball. Not always looking for the boundary. Very strong onside player. Tremendous pull of the ball and hooker. Was a control shot to get off the mark. Just head down. Bottom hand comes into play. Beautifully played.
Well, I think it's his all-round play, Bill, that I've been impressed with of late when they were in Darwin for those few games against Bangladesh. It was smart batting, and it wasn't against a real powerhouse attack, but the batting conditions were tough. The pitch made it hard. It was slow. Just the way he went about it was really intelligent. And Watson decided there was no single there. Sean Marsh is all-round game, and the way he's approaching it, he's matured very quickly.
Very different start to the one we saw from the All-Stars, where it was all guns blazing. Dighton and Gilchrist just went after the Australian attack. This is a quieter start.
Now the bowl, it's 1 for 15.
Hello again. The Tasmanian Tigers will look for their second straight Sheffield Shield win when they meet Victoria at the MCG tomorrow. This year's Mark Webber Challenge begins next week with the biggest field in the event's short history. And the Melbourne Football Club has delisted Nathan Carroll from its playing list. Good night.
Over number three. Beautifully played into the gap. Just the two.
gave us a chance to have a chat to Adam Gilchrist, the captain of the All-Stars. Gilly, a nice start from your bowlers, two young blokes, a big stage for them.
Yeah, very nice. McGoffin gets a nice angle across the left-hander, so that's why we got this offside packed field. But, yeah, I think they're excited to have a bit of a crowd and a bit of TV action.
Oh, big shout, too high, but good pace, good length.
Still got two slips in play, Skipper. Your own footwork and glove work, are you happy with it today?
These cramps are hanging around, mate. I'm not sure I'm going to last the full 20. But
a bit of huffing and puffing.
I reckon. It's good fun, though.
What's happened with the skin folds? Gilly, have you eased out a bit?
I don't know. I'm going to actually attempt to get them recorded tonight and just see where I'm at.
He's got the skins on under that to try and pull it in.
Yeah. Oh, catch
could
it.
Could be out. Oh, he's got it. Yes, he has. Wow, what about that? Drew takes the catch, diving forward, got it between the legs and held onto it. That's a big wicket. And the crowd are loving it. What a big moment now also. For that wicket, it's going to be Andrew Simons coming to the crease. This is a fine piece of cricket for an outfielder. Come in, judged it, had it, topped up, into the groin. Hang on, my son. He does, and that's out. Big wicket. And not Andrew Simons. Brad Haddon coming in. So the loss of two quick wickets, a change in the order.
I tell you what, he's stiff, Sean Marsh. How did he hang on to that? It was in his hands for half a second, and then it bounced all the way around his body and ended up nestling between his legs. Doesn't matter. As long as the ball's dry, it's out, but he can consider himself a little unlucky.
Drew a bizarre dismissal. The first thing he had to do was get to the ball quickly, and when you're sprinting in, the eyes are up and down very hard. He makes brilliant ground, doesn't he? And then, where's the ball gone? Oh, there it is. I'll just squeeze a bit tighter. And kept it above the grass.
And he attacked the ball too. He wasn't frightened of the ball. He came in hard, didn't he? It was always going to be difficult. 2 for 17. Threw him. Got him! There's big shout from behind. No, says the umpire. Rodney Tucker.
Gilly, give us a break, mate. That your wicket keepers don't change.
It was actually appealing because I gloved it. It's a good noise. I could hear something over the commentary there. I was trying to concentrate. I didn't know Bill was in there tonight. G'day, Bill, how are you?
Well, thanks, mate. And I would have gave that out. Don't worry about it, Captain.
Oh, gee.
He's right behind you guys, Gilly.
Oh!
This is good bowling. Just picked up a wicket, beaten the bat. Watson all over the place.
His delivery really leaps, and it's so close to that outside edge. And it just left Watson as well.
This is high ball. This could be out. It may fall in. They're coming from everywhere. He's coming. No, he doesn't make it. Brad Hodge probably misjudged him then. He seemed to be there and at the end had to dive. Over gone. 2 for 19.
$50 saving. I reckon that's a good reason to switch.
Yeah, maybe.
What do you mean, maybe? We'd save $50 on our home and contents insurance if we switched to Amy.
Yeah, that's from your perspective. No, what about a woman's point of view? For once?
Whoa! Are you happy now?
Yes. Yes, I am.
Finally.
What?
Lucky you're with Amy.
It's not a good start by the Australian 11. 2 for 19, 204 the target. Johnny Walker boys are on top here at the Gabba.
They sure are, and just the fact that Gilly can still have two slips in place. Impressive start by the bowlers.
Haddon does well. Waited for it, hit straight through the line.
It's a beautiful piece of batting. This is a talented man, Brad Haddon, and when he gets rocking, He's a very clean hitter. This is his first ball. Look at that. That's a calculated swing of the bat. Beautiful contact, a couple of bounces, and it's over the ropes. Great start.
And you look at the fact it's his first ball, and you think, oh, that's a bit reckless, but it was a straight bat through the line, gave himself room, but the required run rate is 10.75.
Another one. It's better. Well controlled this time through the offside.
It takes a lot of ability to hit straight a fast bowler back over the head. He's done it twice in two balls. He's only faced two balls, Brad Haddon. He's on eight. And he's cleaned them both down the ground.
Comes Brad Hodge. He seemed to just misjudge it in the end because he was taking a little short ones. Didn't make it. Beautifully timed, but just the single. Going back for the second, that's good running.
I think the guys who have been in India will enjoy getting back to Australian soil to get used to the conditions they've grown up playing on, and the pace and the nature of the pitch up here at the Gabba is that you can use the pace of the ball, even though at times it might be a little bit tennis ball like bounce, just sitting down in the pitch a bit, but generally it's got through nicely. You can see that by the bounce and the pace from the bowlers, but that's not bad when you're a batsman willing to play your shots either.
Out of the way with a bit of a top edge.
Not that we're wanting a wicket to fall, Bill, but wait for the roar when Andrew Symons comes out. They love him all around Australia, of course, but especially here. Native to Queensland, and he is ready to go. So look out when he comes to the crease.
It's a wonder when he thought he'd be making a return. When it all happened in Darwin and he was sent home, I wonder when he thought that, you know, this is the date that I want to be back in the Aussie setup. I would say he's in sooner than he probably thought. It'll be four. The top edge there. So Watson getting into the action, and take him into double figures. But he gets away with it because he really flashed the blade.
Got Andrew Symons mic'd up and waiting to go. Roy, can you hear me? Andrew Symons, we're up in the commentary box here, mate. You got us?
Yeah, got you.
How are you feeling? You're about to get out there, the heat's on. Your heart pumping, or are you nice and relaxed?
Oh, mate, we're going to have to play an unbelievable... Someone's going to have to play an unbelievable innings to get us home here, so hopefully that's Hads or Water, and then I can come in and tidy up at the end, maybe.
Oh, I think he's gone. He is. Here's his chance. Harris throws down the stumps. Watson run out. A beautiful piece of fielding. Very aggressive. Chased into the ball. Great throw. There was another one at 3 for 34.
It's not going to be Watson, it's going to be Symons that has to do the job now.
Tremendous ovation for Andrew Symons. That adds to the pressure, I guess. What expect from this tremendous strike of the ball? 3 for 34 after four overs. Enormous pressure, but a wonderful fielding. Great throw. That's the end of Watson for 11. Harris was the thrower.
He's had some impact. Harris took a very good catch to dismiss Hayden, and then a pick up and throw. And now we've got Andrew Symons at the crease. A big moment for him.
Well bowled. Well, they scored 203, the All-Stars. And they've struck back with the ball, 3 for 35. They're all over the Australian 11.
Well, it's an outstanding start. They did it with the bat, now they're doing it in the field. And run outs are key to this form of the game. Harris, he's taken a brilliant catch, and now they're... Here's a brilliant run out also. Watson not even in the frame. Had to be a direct hit. Andrew Simons has got all the pressure on him. He was saying that it was the Haddon-Watson partnership that needed to kick for the Australians. Well, now Simons has to be there for at least 10 overs.
Haddon goes beautifully down the ground. Went away to the onside. It's straight through the line.
Well, this bloke's been the most impressive of the Australian batters by mile. He's just walked out there smoking. Two balls, two fours. He's targeted the straight part of the ground and he's hitting the ball beautifully. And there's another example of it.
What would you call that shot?
Well, there's a fair slab of arrogance attached to it. Slats, he's just exposed all three to the bowler, taking him straight back over his head.
It was a cute little hop just before he laid through the line of the ball.
Donald, backward point, good all around, he'll bowl medium pace. They're on their toes, the All-Stars. I can sense a kill here and an early kill the way they're going. Three quick wickets and 4.3 overs. Field spread now, just the keeper, no slip.
The underdogs, aren't they, the All-Stars? So there'll be an element of support in the crowd. The Aussie loves the underdog. Remember the season when the Australian A team were in the Triangular One Day Series, and whenever the Aussie A's played Australia, everyone was going for the Aussie A's.
Well, you were a part of that, Michael. You were involved, and they just lift. Every time the underdog plays the main Australian team, it is game on because there's enormous amount to prove. It's going to be very tough for the Aussies from here.
Well struck. Not quite off the meat of the bat. We'll get at least three.
Yeah, this time that Andrew Simons. To be fair, he has not been in the best batting form when it comes to playing state cricket. So he's been reselected. Yeah, they did miss him too. There's no doubt he would have a little more balance to the team in India. His form isn't great. Be a great night to find it.
.343.
Summer's coming. Time to get cracking on all those half-finished projects.
So, pick up a proper deal.
Like these finished 4-litre paints, interior and exterior, just $49.75 each. Home, timber and hardware.
The proper hardware store.
Harvey Norman fires up barbecue deals for 4 days only. Scorching savings on all the top brands. Plus, bonus meat tray with every Barbie sold over $500. Plus, bonus gift card up to $100. Don't miss 4 days of hot barbecue deals ending this weekend. Go!
Ryan Harris comes into the attack. He's taken a catch and a run out, so he's running hot. He's coming on from the members' end. Right arm, medium pace. A handy cricketer. Originally from South Australia. Good, honest cricketer. This year playing with the Bulls here in Queensland.
He won't get the bounce of the other two, Ryan Harris. He's not a big man. They've got to start making some hay, this Australian team. The required run rate's edging up towards 11. You can see that there, 10.78. Long gap between the red and the green.
Deep long off now, just a single. Brought the fine leg up and defending the straight hit.
Haddon 17 off 9, and there's no doubt for me now that you look at it, the order changed. Haddon was below Simons, but it all changed when those early wickets fell. And Haddon's out there as a designated hitter. just the nature in which he's playing, he's trying to get Australia into a really positive position, and then they'll be looking to bat more normally with the two hussies. That's a beautiful shot.
Good defensive fielding, good shot, good cricket all round.
He's a brutal hitter, Andrew Symons, enormously powerful man. And any room, and he will jump all over it. It's actually very well done to cut that down. Slower ball, too short, too wide, bang.
This is Dighton, isn't it? Dighton come out and went bang, 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 six all over the place. And they're struggling, not finding the boundaries.
Good running again. They need the singles, but more importantly, they need these stats of Andrew Symons to translate to this game tonight. Look at that. An average of 56 and that strike rate of 170. JB?
If you're going to create a game and a player for it, this is it. Exactly made to play 2020 cricket. They are awesome numbers.
Dot ball, that's well bowled. It's 3 for 49.
Get a cracking deal at Harvey Norman's iPod Bonus Bonanza. Buy any iPod Nano and get a bonus Belkin AC charger. Buy any iPod Classic or iPod Touch and get a bonus charger plus bonus FM tuner. iPod Bonus Bonanza ends this weekend at Harvey Norman.
This weekend only at the Complete Garden. Enjoy 30% off all pots. That's right, 30% off all pots this weekend only. So many styles and colours to choose from. All great quality and 30% off the already great prices. The Complete Garden, 131 Murray Street, Hobart.
The situation, 155 off 84 deliveries. Matt Hodge being a wonderful partnership. Control, real professionals. Found the boundaries, ran hard between the wickets. Maybe a match-winning partnership.
McGoffin into his fourth and final over, and just thought we'd make use of our men out there who are wide up. We'll go down to Mike Hussey as captain of the Aussies. Huss, can you just have a chat with Simo for us and find out how he's going?
What's going on out there, Roy?
I'm going all right. I don't know whether to force it or what, but...
How you guys are going all right? You got a good little partnership going here?
We're trying to pinch some twos out to these long sides. I'm making me crease a bit, mate.
Just remember, backhandle the bowler and you'll be right.
I don't, yeah.
Got Roy. Hey Roy, you got Justin Langer, the old boy. He's about 48 years old. Just come on, so you can put a bit of pressure on him in the field.
Yeah, I can. He's not wide up, is he?
No,
we can
not.
Probably get one to there. He won't be able to throw that far anymore.
Keep Harry's mind on the job.
I've just got to play him, I think.
Yeah, he's bowling pretty well. We can get through him.
Like, he's probably, you know, their best bowler, so unless he gives him one in my zone.
Yeah, he's a very good bowler. Comes from Western Australia, so what do you expect?
I'm just looking to knock it around, knock it into gaps, run hard.
Okay, just watch Langer and Gully.
Maybe two, come on, yeah.
Good arm, Roy.
No!
Got a pretty good arm out there, that Brendan Drew.
Yeah, he's tried to suck us in with a run out there, eh?
Yeah, we don't need a run out now. How's Hads going?
He's going good.
Yeah?
He's striking it nicely, yeah.
He's playing beautifully.
No, 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 no.
keep his mind on the job. Maybe go down and have a little chat to him.
I'll go and talk to him. Just this last, this is his last
get through
one.
This last one. This is McGoffin's last over. We can maybe try and attack some of the other guys.
He, this is his last over. This is his last ball of his spell. So. I delivered the message there for you, Captain.
Thanks, Roy. Not sure if it went in. His eyes look like they're spinning from here.
Yes, yes!
Oh, no,
trouble. Oh, hell of a life there. 3 for 53, see you after these messages.
3 for 53, Australia. Good on you, Roy. Thanks for doing that for me.
That's 3 for 53.
The cricket news and Ford Backyard Series cricket fever has hit, with matches being played everywhere as part of a nationwide competition this summer. The new look six-a-side program being run through cricket clubs around Australia is sure to provide some exciting action.
Can't wait to get stuck in, eh, boys?
Especially now you've got a decent bowler.
Thanks, Mitch. Might even get an over or two yourself.
Let's go get him, Tiger.
3.53 at the Gabba as Mark Nicholas and Mark Taylor joins James Brace, who are in a comfortable position.
Ryan Harris resumes. Tell you what, Tub, we're about to be made obsolete. Commentators, if the players are just going to take over.
Well, provided they keep paying us, it's okay. We're just going to sit up here and watch. That sounds right to me.
An insight though, Nico, into how you actually manage yourself while you're out there. I imagine, especially in this game where it is a bit of a maelstrom mentally, you've got to keep thinking clearly.
It's certainly a maelstrom mentally. I don't think there's any doubt about that. It's been hard for Andrew Simons to time the ball. The bowling's been better, the length has been better. You timed that all right. The Australians just bowled a little short, and Michael Dighton's assault at the start might well prove to be the difference between the sides. But listen, it's great fun to see Andrew Simons back. I think that kind of energy, enthusiasm, an X factor that he's got, I think he's a very important man for Australian cricket right now. Wide called.
Well, it's probably a very good way for Andrew Simons to come back into the Australian side, because there is a bit more of a relaxed atmosphere about this game. He's back in the fold, he's back around the players that he hopes to be playing with next week when the test match is on up here, but he's got a chance to be a bit liberal with the way he plays and talk about the game and just enjoy it. It's probably a good way to come back.
Well, the point is, elite entertainers are rare in any sport, and Andrew Simons is one of those. Now, there were reasons why he was absent, but he's spot on. It's nice to see him back. There we go. The Gabba. It begins Thursday.
And he's in that squad for that match, and the general feeling is that he wouldn't be there unless he was going to play. You wouldn't have him along for the ride. Yeah, this is tremendous bowling. It really is. The other point, I think, is that the All-Stars, with the exception of Gilly, including Langer, who played county cricket, the All-Stars have been playing state cricket. And Australia, most of them have come from India. Simons himself hasn't been in great touch. I know he played well at the Wacker, but he's not been in his best touch. So it's very different for the Australians to come from India and suddenly turn it on tonight, because in a way, this is downtime safe. Just about safe. Tremendous over from Ryan Harris. It's 3 for 55.
The solar lights are fantastic, environmentally friendly. Deck out your backyard, you know, you're all sitting around together, you can all see each other.
Solar path lights, $39.47. Sugarcane mulch, $12.84. Electronic safe, $33. Storage container, $8.98. If you happen to find a cheaper price on a stocked item, we'll beat it by 10%.
We cater for everything outdoors. Bunnings
Warehouse! Lowest prices are just the beginning.
Oh,
3 for 55 to win 149 and only 72 balls remaining. 10 and over was the target, marginally over it when this run chase began. Strokes like that are thrilling to watch, but they're only going for a single. The field is well set. It's based on six fielders on the offside and three on the leg rather than the even spread that we saw when the Australians bowled. And there are less places, fewer places to hit the ball because the bowling is generally a little fuller and a little straighter.
They're going to have to drop the hammer. The Aussies, they're close to 12 and a half and over the required rate because that was terrific. 4 for 203. Very, very good batting performance.
Might be caught, should be caught, and is caught. Dan Cullen, the man down at long on. It's all done for Brad Haddin. We'll see you in a moment. It's 4 for 56.
Afternoon, driver. Would you just mind blowing it?
Hot and spicy.
KFC's Hot and Spicy Fillets Hot Box packs a real punch. With two delicious fiery fillets, supercharged sauce, and your favourite sides. KFC's Hot and Spicy Fillets Hot Box.
Brad Haddin leaves the Gabba, caught at mid-on, and just off air, while the commercials run, Mark Taylor's pointing out how often Brad Haddin has caught it mid-on and mid-off. But let's throw it forward. Here's Michael Hussey, leading Australia tonight in the absence of Ricky Ponting and Michael Clarke. Following him is his brother, David Hussey, then Cameron White. That's got to be the engine room, along with Andrew Simons. These four men have got to do something, well, pretty magical, actually, to turn this around. The rate now up to over 12 and a half and over.
Well, those three guys you talk about, Mark, can do it. There's no doubt they can on this pitch. Mike Hussey will, he'll be the one that'll just try and knock it around mainly until the last few overs. But David Hussey and Cameron White, both really good strikers of the ball.
There's the dismissal of Brad Haddin. Pretty comfortable catch for Dan Cullen in the end. You say knock it around, Tubb, but they need nearly 13 and over. I mean, you can't knock it around when you've got that rate.
Yeah, this is one ground, though, where you can hit the boundaries. Boundaries seem to come in clumps almost at times. You can hit the six and the four together, as we saw Michael Dighton do earlier today.
Good crowd in tonight as well. A few questions were asked about how many would turn up, but there's massive enthusiasm. Oh, there'll always be a Mexican wave. 16,000 people have come to the Gabba this evening for this pipe opener to the new season on nine. We've got much excitement with first New Zealand and then the South Africans, and then for the first time for a long time, two separate one-day series, not a triangular. So the Australians will play five matches against the South Africans and five against the Black Caps in the one-day series that begin after the test matches. This kind of enthusiasm is the way that Australia is going to go over the next few months. We're going to have a summer of fun. Look at that. Four singles and a wicket in the over. Brendan Drew doing it well. No width. That's one of the great things about the bowling. That's far. That's in it. Got it. Got him. Gone. And Michael Hussey has to go. Brendan Drew really is doing it well.
Put your feet up and make yourself more comfortable than you ever imagined. Beat the price rise on Stressless during the November Norwegian promotion. It's time to take the comfort test. Stressless at Euphoria.
Come all on my house, on my house.
Eat well this spring. Coles, proudly Australian since 1914.
David Hussey, brother of Mike, comes to the middle with a mighty task at hand. The rate now more than 13 and over to win this game, so forget knocking it about. Two of ball doesn't do it.
Australian innings in disarray. This is a good piece of bowling. Saw Mike Hussey coming at him, cramped him. Good piece of glove, comfortable catch for Gilchrist. That's the end of the very dangerous Mike Hussey. And it is going to be an uphill battle now for the Australian team. This partnership of Simons and David Hussey is going to have to do an enormous amount of work.
Yeah, and spare a thought for Mike Hussey. It's his fifth game, I think, as Australian captain. All one day as before this game. At least one for that, maybe two. Just the single. It's his fifth game as Australian captain. He hasn't won one yet. He's 0 for 4 so far. I mentioned to him at the toss, what does he think of Capsy? He says he likes it, but at the moment it's not liking him.
Spoken like a true former Australian captain. There he goes. His brother now has to pick it up and run with it.
Adam Gilchrist is behind the stumps. We heard him against England, but let's throw to him. You're on air. It's your scene.
I'm in control. Harris in. Vulture Street. That's down the street. Ooh, good footwork from Gilchrist. Very fluent. Doesn't seem to have lost much in the six-month layoff. Ooh, lost his voice, though. A little bit of atmosphere out here now. Crowd picking up the Mexican wave. Guffey. Very impressed with young Ryan Harris here. Former South Australian has made his way up here to the Queensland Bulls. He's been very impressive all summer. All 10 minutes of the summer so far, but very impressive start for him in Queensland colours. See what he does to his Queensland Bulls teammate.
Gilly, did you talk to the blokes about length? Because Australia were a bit short at times, weren't they?
I think you're right. As we saw, Jeeves, he might have just been a bit too far back of a length, as we say. The guys have, hit a pretty good length. Just general good bowling, good areas, as we like to say. I think it's... got it. That's stiff, that. A bit harsh. Never argue with an umpire, though, do you? I think it shows, as I said when I was facing Tatey, a good length ball is a good length ball in any form of the game, and particularly if you're really premeditating, thinking about trying to hit boundaries, you're expecting all this variation, and a standard delivery can work well sometimes. But that's a nice variation. Atmosphere definitely picking up here though. It's been good. I think these guys that like Ryan and Brendan Drew haven't played a lot in front of big crowds. It's a great experience for them.
Tell you what, that ball is slapping into your gloves. You said earlier you thought the ball was staying in the pitch a bit. Looks to me like it's carrying through nicely.
It's definitely just quickened up a bit. Justin Langer has made the point. And I think as you know, night time really sets in. With a little bit of dew around, but it definitely just quickens up here. I always found batting second in the day-nighters up here was tougher than batting first. Well, that's a good shot. Well, we're going to a break. I guess that's 5 for 71. And good signs for Andrew Simons.
The new limited edition 4 Territory SR2 comes with over $5,500 worth of features at no extra cost. There's alloy wheels, cruise control, sports leather trim, and widescreen DVD player. The Territory SR2. Hurry, it'll be gone before you know it.
5 for 71, the Australians. The last ball of that over, for mine, the best shot of the Australian innings so far. Extraordinary piece of batting. Little bit of room for Andrew Symons, but this is what brings people flooding through the gates.
Got him, as Bill might say. Tell you what, how good a catch is that? We have our first classic catch of the summer.
There's that clearing of the hip again you talked about earlier, James. He really sets up for that shot, doesn't he, Andrew Symons? He sort of stays crouched. Bat doesn't go back a long way, but just clears that front hip again. Awesome power. Ball didn't go more than probably 15 metres off the ground at its highest point.
an over needed to win this game. You'd barely wish for anybody else in the world to be at the wicket to try to do it for you than Andrew Symons. David Hussey's out there with him as well, and Ian Healy is with the Australian coach, Tim Neilson.
Yeah, thanks, Mark. And sorry to interrupt, Simo, but we'll get back to the action. After 8 weeks away in India, we've got Archie, Tim and Charlie Neilson. Welcome home, mate. How's it feeling?
It's nice to be home, Hills. We only had a couple of days or one day back in Adelaide and then jumped on the plane yesterday and headed up here to get organised for this game, but it's certainly nice to be back in Australia and seeing the ball bounce and carry a little bit more than we saw in most of the venues in India over the last month or so.
Yeah, well, this Brisbane wicket seems to be going through nicely. Might be hard to judge because of where you've come from. Nagpur did nothing at the end of the series, and now you come back to Brisbane, maybe a conventional Brisbane, or do you think this has got a bit extra?
It looks to me like a pretty good Brisbane one-day wicket. I think the white ball really does stand out as well, so you can see it bounce and carry. And we've had a few guys bowling up 145, 150 tonight, which we haven't seen all through the test series in India especially. So I think it's a really nice wicket. It might be a nice way for our blokes to get a little bit of a wake-up call and realise they're not playing in India anymore and realise we'll have to do some hard work over the next few days to get ready for the test.
Yeah, that's you, Arch. How you going, mate? Is it good to have Dad home?
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah, why? What's he do at home? That's so much fun.
What do we do?
That's what I do, Charlie.
Okay.
Well, here's your action. How do these come out for you, fellas? Did you enjoy warming up this morning?
That was fun, wasn't it?
Yes.
Yeah, it was a nice day for us today, Hills. We had the kids up so they could have a bowl on the ground and come into the change rooms, which is pretty special for the boys. So it's a nice, fun day to get the season underway.
I've heard they're both very good cricketers too. Getting back to the Indian Tour, mate, what's your wrap-up of the Indian Tour? How did we go against expectations? It seemed to me that the public expectation outweighed what the cricket world thought we were going to do.
The pleasing thing was, I thought, with the squad we took away, having lost a couple of senior players again over the last little period, was that we were able to go over there with everybody expecting us to do well, which is what I like. I don't want people to say, oh, they're a young side or they're an inexperienced side. We'd like to go away and play for Australia and play as well as we can. I think, in the end, we weren't quite as consistent as we would like to be with either bat or ball for the four test matches. And maybe the Indians were able just to grab the momentum in the really big moments in the series. They won a couple of tosses, but then they really did consolidate on the back of that and made big scores in Delhi and then played well in the last test in Nagpur when it was up for grabs and put us to bed, basically, yeah.
Yeah, those two fast bowlers they had too. Geez, they bowled well, didn't they? They sort of outdid our top order.
Yeah, very much so. And they were able to get the ball to swing and reverse, and the wickets were quite benign. So getting the ball to move in the air was critical. They were able to do that really nicely. And Sharma's just coming along. He's, you know, he's 6 foot six or seven. He makes the ball bounce. And maybe that was the difference. We had a couple of our shorter fast bowlers found it difficult to make the ball bounce in those conditions. And, you know, if we've all learned something, it's definitely we need to stand the seam up and make the ball bounce and move in some way, shape or form in those conditions.
It looks like there won't be too much trouble doing that next week. So I wish you all the best. And, boys, thanks for warming up today. And nice to have Dad home. Enjoy tonight. Back to you, fellas.
Andrew McDonald is into the attack, and he's across the boundary rope. And Andrew Symons is a chance. He's a chance. Not a lot more than that. 13.24 and over to win the game. Symons 33 from 26. David Hussey not getting much strike. 7 from 4 balls. Mark Taylor and James Brayshaw are alongside me.
Well, this is the moment, isn't it, for Andrew Symons and for the Australian side. Symons is now set. Dave Hussey's been there for 4 balls. That's probably set in 2020 cricket. If 5 for 87, they look in all sorts of trouble, but with these two at the crease, Cameron White to come, they can still get there. But they need a couple of big overs. With McGoffin now finished his overs and Drew finished his overs, this is the time they need to attack.
He's starting to hit the zone now, Big Roy. Everything's coming out of the middle of his bat. Nice to see the Nielsen boys terrorising the property steward in the Australian dressing room. I don't think they could get any more Australian gear on those two. But this man, Andrew Simons, has got his eye in. And if he can stick around for the next half an hour, look out.
At the moment, the guys are only getting hit down the ground. And that's a measure of how good the bowling is. Mid on and mid off are in business. Extra cover, straight mid wicket, all in business. Wouldn't it be a thing if Simons could pull this off tonight? Look how few runs have been scored on the leg side. It's a great testament to the quality of the bowling. Guys fit and practiced in state cricket and really up for it. What an opportunity for them. The Emirates All-Star Challenge. And just out of the reach of a sprawling extra cover. You can sense this crowd here, 16,000 people willing Andrew Simons to stay at the wicket and willing someone to stay with him.
Just be the thing that ignites his season. You know, he's been out of touch, we've spoken about it, his productivity has been down, but on the big stage he's come out. He was a bit scratchy early, it's starting to come together.
That was hit so hard I can't even tell you whether it's a catch or not. It's 5 for 92.
Australia's favorite beer boasts its greatest ever promotion, VB Top Ticket. You and a mate, just one mate, can meet up with Warney in London, Mark Webber in Monaco, Costazu in Vegas, Mick Fanning in Hawaii, or the Living End in Japan. Buy a case of VB or VB Gold and go to vbtopticket.com to enter. 5 top tickets, which one's yours?
David Hussey replaced Michael Hussey. Undone by a good bit of bowling. Catch there for Adam Gilchrist, rolling back the years. David Hussey has 8. Andrew Simons has 37. And we have Dan Cullen into the attack. 2006, his big year, must seem a long, long way away. This is his first exposure really back in the true big time. He talked himself up. A lot of good judges thought a lot of him. Now, what's Roy going to do to him? Nice.
There was no guessing what he's going to try and do to him. He's going to try and hit him for a number of boundaries or over the boundary if he can, so it'll be a good test for him.
There's the first of them. Tubby Taylor's on the money, and so's Roy.
Well, that's just a short arm jolt. That wasn't even the full Monty. And that's 7 or 8 rows back.
I can't think that a young finger spinner could have a more difficult job. Oh! Beautifully bowled. What a response that is. Very clever. Change of pace, a change of length. Look at that. The seam's different. That's almost to the old arm ball. Really cleverly bowled.
Nice. I'll be interested to see how many arm balls he bowls, because I reckon he's going to bowl a lot of them. I'll be interested to see how many he will toss up. That'll be the big key. There's Darren Lehman on the left there and Greg Chappell, the coach of the ACA All-Stars team, on the right. Quite happy at this stage, I'd suggest.
Dropped. Missed chance. And it's Simons as well. So we've already learned something about Dan Cullen. Bowl, he's got a good heart. He came back from that big six and he might have had his man on another day, or maybe just a year ago. That's a tremendous shot. That is a superb strike. Game on, 13 from that over, 5 for 105.
What's the bottom line on Nissan's end-of-year sale? You can own any new Nissan now with no repayments until 2010. Like X-Trail ST from $31,990 drive away plus $1,000 free fuel. Or Pathfinder with $2,000 free fuel. Or Patrol Wagon with $2,000 free fuel, free bull bar, tow bar and driving lights. What's the bottom line on Nissan's end-of-year sale? No repayments until 2010. See your Nissan dealer now.
It's a diminished red line only because of the explosive start. Barely ever seen anything like the way Michael Dighton played with Adam Gilchrist. It was devastating. Here's Dan Marsh.
Oh!
Ah, now then. Simon Kanic has caught Andrew Simons to a groan around the Gabba. But Dan Marsh has his man. So, for that matter, does Adam Gilchrist, who brought him on to bowl. This is a tremendous performance from the All-Stars.
Roll of the eyes from Dan Marsh. He can't believe it. He just rolled this one out. And everyone on the ground thought that a person in the third row was going to pick that one out, but that was a fairly easy pop-up ball for Simon Kanic, and that's the end of the most dangerous batsman in the Australian lineup. Andrew Simon's gone for 45, and it's going to be tough now for the Aussies.
Well, that was brilliantly bowled, actually, from Dan Marsh. He took a chance there. He knew Simons would be after him. He tossed it up, bowled it slow, bowled it wide of off stump. He said, well, you can take me downtown for six if you like, but if you don't get it in the middle, I'm going to get you. And that's exactly what he did. Beautifully bowled. First ball, tossed it up, wide of off stump. Simons couldn't get there and just popped up the catch to Simon Kanic.
It's the length and the width, isn't it? It's almost as if it was the bowler doing the premeditating, knowing with some certainty that Simons would come at him. They've played some very good cricket tonight, the boys in red. Very good cricket. Cameron White is now out there with David Hussey, though not on strike. And we just have been, what a good cricketer, Dave. You know, David Hussey is a tremendous cricketer, isn't he?
He is a terrific player. He's going to have to bat very well. Have a look at Dan Marsh here. It was a good bit of bowling, but yeah, here we are. He knew that was a bullet dodged. That could easily have ended up being a massive maximum. Instead, that was the end of Andrew Simons. Played a lot of cricket, this bloke. He's a good boy, Dan Marsh. And he enjoyed that, I reckon.
I tell you what, he could end up with some really good figures here today. 1 for 3 he's got. Australia have got to keep going for it, haven't they? They've got to score at 15 runs per over. So he's going to keep tossing him up, and he might get a few more wickets before the night's over.
I like massive maximum, JB. That's a double M. It's new commentary speak. It's a double M.
Well, you can get the one that just apologises over the rope, Nico, and then you can get the one that explodes into the top deck. And that's what I thought was going to happen with that one, but credit to Dan Marsh. It was a terrific piece of bowling.
Still, I think looking back, a very useful outing for Andrew Simons. I think he would have not just got rid of cobwebs, but got rid of demons.
No question. I think it's if he's going to play in the test match, I know it's a totally different form of the game, but some touch, some hand-eye touch has come back to him.
6 from the over, but a wicket 2. It's 6 for 1-1-1.
The First Home Owners Grant has now increased, meaning you can build or purchase with little or no deposit. And with Finance Brokers of Tasmania, you'll have access to a wide range of lenders to ensure you get the loan that suits you. I bought my first home back in the 1980s with the assistance of the First Home Owners Scheme, a very daunting experience at the time, but it all turned out well with some solid advice and support. And you can expect that same sort of help from Finance Brokers of Tasmania, where smart people go for loans.
6 for 1-1-1. Australia need 93 runs from the last 6 overs. 15 and a half runs per over needed from here on in. The All-Stars in a great position at the moment. McGoffin bowled beautifully, 2 for 21 off the top. Cameron White has just got no choice but to go go hard right from the word go. I've been joined in the commentary box by Michael Slater and Bill Laurie, and wouldn't mind being an all-star at the moment.
I would, but you've got two good strikers of the ball at the crease. They've done very well for Victoria in the one-day games and the 2020 matches in Hussey and White. White in particular, one of the biggest hitters going around, but it certainly is a big assignment. One rate required 15 runs per over. It's been a great effort by the All-Stars. They've bought a much better length. They've been up and there's been a bit of movement off the seam as well. Taking one or two good catches.
So, Bill, what you're saying is because there's two Victorians at the crease, there's still a chance. Is that what you're saying?
The only problem is the Victorian bowler's bowling at them.
They're everywhere. But you certainly can't ride Australia off. It looks pretty grim when you see a required run rate of over 16. There's no doubt David Hussey's style, which to me is a little unorthodox. He hits so powerfully over extra cover. He's sort of a bit of a lasso player. In that, I mean, he hits the ball quite square.
Interesting part about this match, the big partnership between Hodge and Langer was traditional batting. You know, once they got the flying start from Guyton, they hit a lot of boundaries into the gaps, and now it's the reverse situation. They've got to hit a lot of sixes and fours from here on in for the Australian side.
Yeah, it's crucial, isn't it? Those first six overs, obviously crucial in the 2020 match. If you can get someone like a Michael Guyton did earlier today to get you off to a flyer and get something like 50 or 60 runs in those first six overs, then you could bat normally. The All-Stars with 2 for 73 after six overs earlier today.
It's well struck, but straight to long off.
It's just such a different mindset now, isn't it? The batsmen, they go out there and there's no fear. To start off the way Haddon did in this innings, the way that innings in the All-Stars, Guyton, I mean, there's no fear. They're going out with such confidence, and that's a difference in the young batters today.
Chance of a run out, safely home. Good fielding and good running.
Well, I suppose if you look at the game, it's 20 overs. You're backing yourself, you're not going to lose 10 wickets in 20 overs. Really, the fear of losing a wicket has been taken out of the game, almost completely out of the batting. Sides generally have about 8 of their 11 are pretty good batsmen. So you just back yourself that one or two of them are going to come off in the 20 over period and you're going to be able to make a big score.
Oh, he would have been in trouble with a direct hit or even a take. 15 overs gone. Cadditch was the fieldsman, 6 for 118.
Explore prime liquidation at Rosny Park. High quality solid teak furniture, homewares, mirrors, artwork, terracotta and ornaments. All at prices you won't believe. For something unique, call into prime liquidation Rosny Park. Open 7 days, just up from the Cheesecake Shop.
Did you know by supporting IGA, you're supporting some of your Tasmanian local sporting clubs? Think quick.
Not only sporting clubs benefit from IGA, but also some Tasmanian charities and events.
So by shopping at IGA, we're giving back and supporting our local heroes.
6 off 30. Run rate required now 17.2 per over. So they've got to go now. Cullen's got to be the target, the off spinner. He bowled a very good over to Simons, despite the fact he was hit for 6. Good variation, a bit of flight. Just the single.
Oh, Dan Marsh will be saying thank you very much. He's come on to bowl one over. He's picked up Andrew Simons, first ball, and now he's off.
He's out.
New
of
little
there.
Beauty.
He might have pulled himself out of the attack. Skip, I've had enough. Just the one will do me. Got you the big wicket of Andrew Simons. 45 from 35. Simo, a welcome return to international cricket.
Daniel Marsh out first ball with the bat. Picks up Simons with the ball. It's well bowled, good full length.
I heard James Brayshaw, Mark Nicholas talking about Andrew Simons and how it was a nice little innings for him, and yeah, just to shrug off a few demons. Rather big thing, I think, about this game is he's back in the dressing room with guys and back at training with the guys that were somewhere in India, some weren't. That was probably where a lot of the demons were coming from. Let's not forget what happened to Darwin. It seemed it was a player push. You know, they were the one who had concerns about certain things. that Andrew Simons had going on in his life. So I think the biggest thing that's happened this in the last couple of days is back in the dressing room with them all.
Hussey goes long, all the way. He's a good striker of the ball, is David Hussey. He's a good cricketer in all forms of the game.
Used his hands well here, David Hussey. Reached out and got that ball. It was a full toss, but he actually made it into a full toss with a bit of extra stretch. Reached out and got it before it bounced, and then had the power to hit it for six.
Goes again, high ball, might be out. It's behind the side screen, he is out. Hodge takes the catch, that's good bowling. Threw it up, enticed a big hit down the ground. They're all over the Australian 11 at 7 for 127.
Real trouble now. But you were right, Bill. You mentioned that the last over he got hit, smacked for six, and he came back nicely to finish his first over. Even again, he's been smacked for six, and he throws it up there. That is gutsy bowling. And 7 for 127 Australia. There is just over four overs remaining. It's looking at an impossible task now for the Aussies.
And once again, it was that wide ball, wasn't it? A little bit slower, but thrown wide. Generally, we talk about the quicker men bowling straight, no width. With the spinners, looking to get wickets. Batsmen are looking for straight balls they can hit down the ground. That was good bowling from Dan Cullen, very much like Daniel Marsh in his last over. Threw it wide, batsman couldn't reach it and hold out the long off.
Xavier Doherty at the crease. And we're seeing the benefit of spin too. You've got to make the pace when you're a batsman. A little bit of fight, just a little bit of turn. It's good to see Cullen back playing at this level. He started off brilliantly early on in his career, and he's just struggled a bit, which can happen with young spinners. He's got another opportunity now. He's played one test and a handful of one-day internationals.
Oh, nice, Daniel!
7 for 127.
Wins International Summer of Cricket. Brought to you by our telecast partner, KFC, where the chicken is delivered and prepared fresh. Can't beat that taste.
Hang on for the ultimate high-altitude thriller.
You want to kill me, don't you? Take a number and get in line.
Sylvester Stallone and John Lithgow. Unmissable action. Cliffhanger. Tonight after the cricket on Win.
7 for 127. Not an impressive batting card there, but you can't take anything away from the bowlers. They bowled well with the new ball. The spinners are doing the job as well. Doherty beaten by a change of pace.
Probably learnt from how the Australians bowled, actually, Bill. There are a couple of the bowlers, Jeeves in particular, who got the length wrong. It was too short. The All-Stars have had nice balance in their bowling lineup, and their length has been right. Some tall bowlers, McGoffin, he's tall, lanky, a bit like Glenn McGrath. 2 for 21, and then Drew, 2 for 41. But the early wickets are always going to stall an innings, even if it's 20-20. It was very much down to the middle order, who looked like they were going, and Andrew Simons was the powerhouse they got rid of.
I think Mark Taylor, I think Dighton was the key to this match. He just come out and he went bang. I mean, the Australians were bowling with good enough pace. And he just took them on.
I think he did right, Bill. He probably won't get the man of the match because someone like Brad Hodge will probably get it, who end up with 60-odd not out. But to me, that little innings in the first five overs, he only faced 13 balls for 34. And that set the tone for the innings. And it was always from the time that he hit about 17 off the first over, you felt that the All-Stars were going to make at least 180.
We'll have a look at some of the highlights. We'll see that threshed away through cover. It's a brilliant shot, and it's well fielded as well. That man, Harris, has really been in this match, but Dighton was a key. They were probably lucky, the Australian, when he ran himself out. It was really, he did play well. That was a first six. There he goes over cover point. He just struck the ball so cleanly, coming off a 95 against the Vicks at the MCG. That's brilliant batting.
Well, early on it was the width and the bounce, and then he was just hitting straight through the line. Bit of a miscue there, but he gets away with it. And
That cameo set it up for the All-Stars. 2-0-3 they made.
Well, there's a big one, but has he got the distance? Mid-wicket's coming around. On the bounce. Dyett and the fieldsman, they pick up two. He's been around a long time, Dyett, but he's a very handy cricketer. He lost form a season or two ago, but he's bounced back.
I love it when two batsmen stride out. One of them's Adam Gilchrist. Hasn't played for a few months, but the Aussies are probably fearing what Gilly's going to do to them. And then Dyett launches an assault straight up. It was a great start to what has been an exciting night, that's for sure. Be another two to the Aussies. Not good enough. They need fours and sixes.
Yes, it gets tough when you need 72 off 20 balls, doesn't it? Your mass is any good. Twos are no good. Threes minimum, and you need fours and sixes, as you said.
Cameron White's a tremendous striker of the ball. It's just too big of an assignment. Haven't got wickets in hand either. He's got to do all the work, and his opponent knows him well. McDonald. There he goes. Could be out, should be out. Oh, you beauty! That, what a catch, Dyett, and giving the man of the match, for goodness sake.
That might have secured it for him. How good was that? The one hand straight up, and it just goes thump into the back of it. What a catch.
Cameron White can't believe it. Beautifully struck. Was flat, was hard. He's inside the rope. Up he goes. Oh, what a ripper. A classic catch. Beautifully caught. Give him a Johnny Walker, for goodness sake.
He might take the KFC instead. Oh, he's launched himself skyward. One hand, and it just stuck.
That was one of the features of the modern-day cricket, isn't it? They do catch well, and they throw well, and Cameron White cannot believe his luck.
Cameron White thinks that six as soon as he's hit that ball. Now, Michael Dyett was in about 10 metres off the rope, but he was in there to try and stop the two, so he wasn't really out of position. And he went back straight away, so you can't say he misjudged it. He did everything he possibly could in the end. Took a screamer. What a catch that is.
He even turned to have a look where the rope was. He set himself, and it was getting away from him, wasn't he? Just, oh, I'll just have a go here. And it went whack.
Yeah, well, it'll be easy to say that he should have been back on the rope, but he's in off the rope because he's looking to save the two. He's trying to keep the shots down the ground to one, so that's why he's there. Takes a couple of steps back, and it's so well hit. That's all he can do. Did it brilliantly.
And those people in the crowd will never forget that catch. 10 or 12 metres back there. It was off the ground. It was well struck. It was a hard hit ball. It wasn't a lollipop by any means. In the end, he judged it beautifully. Cameron White goes bang. That's six. Don't have to run for that. Sorry, Cameron.
You know what that reminds me of? It was a similar catch on the other side. Same position, the other side. Adam Dale. Remember that one years ago? It was to catch Phil Emery. It's a state game, so Phil Emery's hit one down in the deep, and it was a spectacular catch, just like that one.
Running back, just on the right-hand side it was. Adam Dale.
Oh, nice!
Cohen pushes this one through. Well, it's all over Red Rover. The All-Stars have done a great job. They made 203 and have defended that total grandly. Some good bowling by the new ball bowlers, and the spinners have backed them up.
Yeah, Peter Siddle has been the new man. We've forgotten about him in all the excitement of the catch, but he's the new batsman for Australia.
What about Tubby, who's man of the match?
I've already said mine before the catch. It was Dighton before the catch, but that has definitely secured it for me.
I'm happy with that too. There's something about catches though, something like that that you'll remember and you'll tell your grandkids, your kids, everyone about. And the innings might be forgotten, but that catch will always stick with him and ours as well.
Well, we still talk about John Dyson, don't we?
at the Sydney Cricket Ground. That was 100 years ago. It took a magnificent catch. Wasn't any better than this one, though. This is a ripper.
Were you commentating on that game, Bill, 100 years
there,
ago?
I was there. Richie and I were there. Don't you worry about that. And another catch. McDonald in the action this time. They're gone for all money, the Australians. It's been a very good performance by the Johnny Walker boys. They've really defended that total well.
Hey, the other thing this might create is Gilly might come out of retirement. They're the underdogs, the All-Stars. They've turned up and they've given a pasty to the Australians. Gilly's captain leading the way. Got a played a little cameo too, didn't he? 20 on. He might come out of retirement.
I think what it does show you is it just shows you how important it is to have some form, to play on these sort of pitches. I suppose cricket hardened, and that's what the All-Stars side are. They've played a couple of rounds of Sheffield Shield cricket, a few Ford Ranger Cup matches, so they're in good form. They know the conditions, and they've looked a better side right from the word go, right from that time that Michael Dighton hit that six.
And they lost some quick wickets, and then, of course, we saw Hodge and Langer in a very sensible professional partnership, got them to 203, and they've defended it grandly here. They've caught well, they've bowled a very good line to length, just the odd no ball. But a good performance. Sean Tate.
And 18 overs completed, so two overs remaining, but one wicket. That's all the Aussies have got left. And if we go down to Adam Gilchrist, Gilly, who's your man of the match?
Oh, gee. Who opened with Dighton? What was that bloke's name? Dighton, I think you got us rolling. And as I think I overheard you there saying about that catch, you just closed
catch.
It out. That was magic, wasn't it?
Now, listen, are you coming out of retirement now? This is a pretty steady performance, Skipper.
No. I tell you, I'm feeling not too bad at the minute, but I wouldn't mind. Well, I don't want any camera or earpiece in my ear about 9 o'clock tomorrow morning. I'm going to be hurting. I've got a book signing tomorrow. Did I mention my book yet? No, I didn't. I'm not sure I'm going to be able to write. That's stiff.
Got him, it's all over. Very good performance. They bowled him out for 139. A very good effort. Good batting performance, and they've backed it up in the field. Some good fielding, good bowling, good all-round performance.
Yeah, quite appropriately, it's a ball that's fallen straight that gets the final wicket. That's where the All-Stars have bowled probably better than Australia did earlier today. They've bowled straighter, and the quicks have generally bowled fuller. And, McDonald knocks over Sean Tate, and in the end, they win the game by a comfortable 65 runs.
It's a big target, 203, but they had some good strikers. The top order didn't get away. Marsh, Hayden, Watson, Haddon, Simon's got 45 off 35, but really they needed some big hitting early on, one felt, chasing that total. They couldn't do it. Full credit to the bowlers and their fielding. They caught well, run outs as well. Good all-round performance, and all the bowlers were consistent. Drew was a little bit inconsistent, so it's all over here at the Gabba. We'll come back after a short break. In fact, we'll keep going. We see because Heels is getting ready out on the field. As there's a captain coming off. The umpire's had an easy job.